Joe White. Thursday night, he tore up Boston Garden. He hit Houston with 29 points, 17 in the third quarter as the Celtics eliminated the Rockets. For Washington, Phil Chenier is out of his shooting slump. Friday night, when the Bullets eliminated Buffalo in a tough seven-game series, Chenier came away with 39 points. But the little man who sets up the Bullets' attack is Kevin Porter. He's only 5'11". He led the NBA in assists. And in four regular season games against the Boston Celtics, Porter set up 20 points and outing.
You'll see the best in basketball when you watch the NBA. When you watch the NBA on CBS.
And welcome to a jam-packed Boston Garden and the playoff series that everyone has been waiting for, the defending world champion Boston Celtics against the Washington Bullets. This is game one of that series. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Brent Musburger, along with Oscar Robertson. Oscar, you've spoken to both coaches, all the players, the officials. What can we look for this afternoon?
Well, Brent, the coaches said they're not nervous. It's all up to the players right now. Both teams are ready to play. No real serious injuries. The players are already prepared. This is a big game, a real big game.
I want to ask you about Mike Reardon. He was kicked Friday night in that Buffalo game. How is he?
I talked to Mike before the game. He said he feels fine. He said he has to play in this game, whether he's hurt or not. But he said his leg is fine right now.
All right. It's just as Oscar said. The first game of a playoff sets the tempo for it. That's why this one is so important. I'll be back with Sonny Hill to take a look at these two teams in depth in just a moment.
You're hot tonight.
Yeah. So's his pipe.
Maybe it's your tobacco. Try mine.
Sir Walter Raleigh Special Mixture.
Sir Walter Raleigh Special Mixture, a blend of Kentucky Burley specially cut to pack right and smoke cooler.
Hey, this special mixture really smokes cool.
Flavor to spare.
Quality pipe tobaccos from Sir Walter Raleigh. Special mixture, regular and aromatic.
A partner is someone you get together with to get something done. An auto partner is someone you get together with to get something done on your car. You'll find auto partner stores with the brand name auto parts and tools you need to take personal care of your car. And you'll find auto partner service centers with professional mechanics to do the work for you. Either way, Auto Partner is always on the driver's side.
Auto Partner's always on the driver's side.
Back in the Boston Garden, the Washington Bullets taking their final warm-up shots. Sonny Hill has moved alongside of me. Sonny, there are so many things to say about this series. What would you like to point out for our audience? Something they can watch as it unfolds.
I think the big key in this whole series, Brent, will be the play of Paul Westphal and Nick Witherspoon. Both of these players have the ability to come off the bench and get involved in offense almost instantly.
And I know that you have been taking a look at a regular season game involving the Boston Celtics and the Washington Bullets. You picked out some highlights that can illustrate the points that you want to make about these two substitutes.
Yes. Paul Westphal comes off the bench, and he really gets involved in the offense in a lot of different ways. Not only is he a great outside shooter, as you see here, but he has the ability to go one-on-one, which is not normally a Boston Celtic trait, but he does it so well. Nick Witherspoon does the same thing for the Washington Bullets. He comes off the bench, he gets involved in the game right away, and the latter part of the season, he was coming on very rapidly for them and carried over into the playoffs. The key matchup in the ball game will be the matchup between Dave Cowens and Elvin Hayes. You'll notice that Dave Cowens will play him one-on-one a lot of times, but sometimes he'll get help. As you see, John Havlicek drops off and tries to intimidate and double up. When that happens, Elvin will find the open man, or like in the game we had last week, he will force the shot to the basket. Elvin Hayes has the ability to force Dave Cowens away from the low post. And here's what Elvin Hayes will have to do when he forces him away. He will make sure, or at least try to make sure, that he can contain the outside shooting of Dave Cowens. I would be sort of remiss if I didn't point out that the classic matchup in this series is the one between Paul Silas and Wes Unseld. Notice how Paul boxes out Wes Unseld and allows Dave Cowens to come in and get the rebound. And conversely, you will see the same thing at the other end of the floor when Wes Unseld will be boxing out Paul Silas. And the thing is, we want the fans around the country to be aware of the many things that happen away from the ball.
Sonny, Boston eliminated Houston in five, but Washington had to go seven to oust Buffalo. You were at the Bullets practice yesterday. Are they a tired basketball team?
No, I don't think they're a tired basketball team. I think the seven-game series was good for them. It sort of gets them mentally ready to deal with the tremendous amount of pressure in this upcoming series. And as you know, the Celtics have been through this many times before.
All right, Sonny Hill, we'll look forward to seeing you at halftime. These two teams met four times during the regular season. They split. Statistics are even, although Boston turned over the ball more. So watch that, and we'll be back with the tip-off.
How are you feeling? Any pain?
No.
Ed Clark is going back to surgery. Fragile body tissue has failed to heal properly and ruptured. Can anything be done to help tissue heal, to help avoid still another operation? A mesh made of Marlex plastic interlaces with body tissue and gives it strength. Who developed the plastic that's helping patients avoid a return to surgery? The same company that makes fine products for your car. The Phillips Petroleum Company. Surprised?
Eric is back. New Eric Tips. A long, daring shape. A big, bold taste in a tip cigar. Smoking satisfaction that's been a long time coming. Discover new Eric Tips. The most interesting idea since the blonde. Eric Tips. Natural, menthol, or cherry flavor. Bold new companion to famous regular size Eric.
NBA playoffs will continue after this word from your local station. Is it the fighting that lures sports fans to hockey games these days? Watch 60 Minutes later today on CBS.
Maybe this isn't the year to build a new house, but you can still make your old house look like new with GAF roofing and siding. Of course, if you only need a new roof, GAF's Timberline roofing comes in lots of colors and wood-like textures. Or if all you need is siding, there's a handsome variety of GAF Vanguard vinyl sidings that never need repainting. And GAF roofing and siding is maintenance-free. And today, that's almost better than a new house.
Last year was a rotten year for cars. Volkswagen sales were down. Vega, down. Pinto, down. Toyota, down. Gremlin, down. Datsun, down. Capri, Opel, Mazda, down. Of these leading small cars, last year only one was up, Fiat. It was our best year ever.
Channel 2, New York.
Give it all you got, take your very best shot, and may the best team win. The time is now, the name of the game is action. They're on the floor, and they're ready to score, so let the game begin. And let's see how the ball's gonna bounce today.
NBA Playoffs, sponsored by quality pipe tobaccos from Sir Walter Raleigh, regular, aromatic, and special mixture, and by Chevrolet. Chevrolet makes sense for America.
When you watch the NBA on CBS, NBA on CBS.
Back at the Boston Garden, where the world champion Boston Celtics are going to be introduced to a standing ovation as they prepare to start game one of this Eastern Conference NBA final against the Washington Bullets. And listen to this crowd. 143 playoff games for Hondo Havlicek, the best field goal shooter in the NBA, and then the big center, Dave Collins. Havlicek, Nelson, and Collins out there, and now it'll be the guards. Cheney is first. JoJo White will be the fifth to come off of Tommy Heitzen's bench. There's Heinzen, John Killalay, the Boston assistant, talking to JoJo White. Paul Westfall, who will be the first reserve guard off the bench, will be out there. Coaching matchup is an interesting one because Casey Jones on the left is the head man at Washington. He played on 8 championship teams with Boston. Tommy Heinsohn, a former teammate, is on the right. There are the starting lineups.
You know, Brandon, we should watch how Chenier does in this game. Here are the officials here.
Richie Powers on the left and Manny Sokol on the right. Bob Rakel is the alternate.
If Chenier starts to score, Boston will not be able to drop JoJo White off on Chenier. Because I think Cheney will have to stay on top of him because Chenier is a very good shooter. If he's shooting well, but he hasn't been up to the last game.
Hey,
Big E goes to work early.
Havlicek picks up Reardon. Nelson is on Unseld. So Collins is over on Hayes. That's what we expected to see. Here is Reardon with the game's first shot.
Well, I think he's out of his slump. If those two guys, Reardon and Chenier, break out of their slump, they could be very tough.
Chaney brings it down for the Celtics. They go to Collins, who is up high, and Hayes is on him. Here is White. Chaney is on the left side. Got it back.
And it falls in.
Pressure right away.
I noticed that one play that Boston runs from the top of the key when they hit Cowan. Watched the defense that pretty well that time.
Unseld inside to Chenier.
Wow. The two guys have been in the slump of Washington and scored their first basket.
The Bullets have hit their first two shots. Here's Collins with his first attempt.
Hey, we're in store for a great basketball game.
Has the ball. Havlicek watching him. Left corner. Finally they miss and Collins has the board. Bullets back well on defense. Porter is on White. They use a pick from Collins.
That was a great pick that time by Dave Collins. He got down there. Nothing happened. So he comes up. Sets a pick on JoJo White's man. He hits a jump shot.
Celtics lead by 2. Porter back for the Bullets. Porter handling the ball a lot. Chenier now out away from the basket. Inside to Wes Unseld. 3 Celtics at the board. Nelson with a rebound. Here comes White. No fast break opportunity. Nelson. JoJo White. Switch off and Reardon's on him. Will they go to Havlicek against Porter? Unseld with a rebound. Porter back in a hurry for Washington. Retrieves it.
Yes, it does. The great pass. Reardon didn't really get to see that pass then.
Hayes with his first shot. Not there. Chenier with an offensive rebound. We are
tied. Hey, that's good rebound by, that time by Chenier, and I think he thought he got fouled.
2 he's field goals inside for Chenier.
He's still talking to the official.
White outside. Well, there's a whistle by Manny Sokol.
Six. Move.
Oh, it's on Reardon.
You can watch Chenier right here. Gets inside of JoJo White. Good jumper in anyway. Gets it right in.
JoJo White. Unseld badly knocked away. Porter will retrieve it for Washington. Brings it up on the right-hand side. Reardon is ahead of him. Porter down the baseline.
Oh, but see the little guy penetrate that time. That's what we were talking about earlier. If Chenier is hitting, they got to keep Chaney on top of him. That means little Porter could grab for the basket a little bit better on White than he can against Chaney.
Collins back to Chaney. Quickly they come to Elvin Hayes. Collins is there and he ties him up. Hold on to Richie Powers. We've got a foul on Collins. Tommy Heinsohn onside the ball.
Yeah, that was a good defense that time by Dave. I thought he got the ball.
Game is tied at 8. We are just underway in the Boston Garden. Kevin Porter controlling it for the Washington Bullets. This is Chenier. Chaney has him.
Yeah, they're taking a lot of time to get it going here.
Elvin Hayes, Collins leaning against him, trying to muscle him. Hayes turn around.
Yes, he gets it there. I tell you, you know, it seems to me that they're going to let Collins and Hayes play a little tougher. Because they're pushing each other. But this is the playoff game, and it may get a little rough out there.
Celtics trail it by 2 points. Don Nelson back to Collins. Misses the drive, but JoJo White has it. Back to Don Nelson. Over to Havlicek. Hayes and Collins battling. They've stepped out of bounds as he tried to retrieve it. He touched it last. So it goes to Washington. Now we've got a timeout call by Casey Jones. Saw something he wants to go over at this point, Oscar.
I just noticed that Collins and Hayes are really going at each other. You know, you talk about two great athletes with a lot of ability. They're really shoving each other, pushing. But that time on the rebound, they fought hard, and Collins knocked it out of bounds. So it's going over to Washington.
Hey, America.
You sound excited, Chevrolet.
We are. There's a little good news to talk about.
Yay!
And a little bad.
Boo!
First, the bad news. Prices of the best-selling import have just been raised, ranging by model from just over $100 to almost $500.
What's the good news, Chevy?
Some of our new small cars have new low prices.
Yay!
Our new Monza S hatchback coupe is priced $305 less than our Monza 2 Plus 2.
Nice news, Chevy.
Our new Nova S coupe, our lowest-priced Nova, is priced $349 less than the base price of the recently announced limited edition compact from Chevy's nearest sales competitor.
Good old Chevy.
We wanted you to know, America, that while some car prices are going up, Chevrolet has all kinds of low prices. From Vega, the lowest-priced American hatchback and station wagon, to Impala, America's lowest-priced popular full-size car. That's why we say
Chevrolet makes sense for America.
You know, you have a nice head of protein there. You notice how I call hair protein? Hair is practically all protein. The beating hair takes, it can lose protein. That can make it lull and lifeless. This is a greaseless hair groom. It's called Menin Protein 29 because it's got protein in it. Protein that actually gets absorbed into the hair. Yeah, right into the hair. Menin Protein 29 helps your hair look thicker, fuller, really healthy.
Protein 29. It's available in spray, gel, and liquid.
You are watching the two NBA teams with the best records during the regular season. Both of these ball clubs won 60 outings. The home court advantage was settled in a dramatic Friday night contest won by Boston 95-94. Phil Chenier, who has the basketball, did not play in that game.
Right now, the Boston's going to come out for a little pressure because they can't afford to let those shooters get inside.
Hayes has it knocked away. Here comes Mr. Hustle. Collins has to slow it up. Now he goes up against Chenier. Not there. Hayes battling. Loose ball. Comes up for Washington. Corner to rear. And Nelson jumped over. The ball hit the top. There was no foul called in that situation.
But the Red Hat is tough in that situation. Anytime you make those lateral passes against the Celtics, they can be very tough because they really don't play well.
Havlicek with the basketball. Over to Collins. Now they move to Cheney. He's hit 4 points, but it's set.
Well, this is what he did against Houston down there. And if he can do it tonight, this afternoon, I should say, look out, Washington.
Tied at 10. Porter with the ball for the Bullets. Goes to Wes Unseld. Unseld to Elvin Hayes.
Soft shot. Right in.
White time.
Don Chaney.
White time.
Called a timeout. He was talking to Manny Sokol.
Don Chaney called time. It's white time. White
time. Here's Sokol talking to the scoring table.
He may have a small problem, I think, Brent.
We'll have to wait and see. Chaney sits down over there on the Boston bench. Talking to Tommy Heinsohn and John Killalay. And we'll see what the problem is when we come back.
Gee, aren't Frenchmen terrific?
Yeah, why can't guys back home dress like that?
So slim, so
rich.
Oh, he's coming over.
It's easy to be mistaken for a Frenchman in a brigade shirt from Arrow. Slim, trim, very European.
Bonjour, mademoiselles. Parlez-vous, American?
He's American.
You really think so?
Brigade from Arrow. No wonder American men look so good.
Let's compare the legroom for passengers in the front seat of America's most luxurious cars. Chrysler Imperial, 42.8 inches. Lincoln Continental, 43.3 inches. Cadillac Eldorado, 43.4 inches. Fiat 128, 43.8 inches. More than the Imperial, the Continental, the Eldorado. Now that's luxury.
This is a good way to show you how well New Superhold from Vitalis holds my hair in place. New Superhold is really different. It's a pump spray, not an aerosol. In laboratory tests under windy, humid conditions, it held hair in place three times longer than the leading men's aerosol spray. And up here, you can see how nervous I look. I mean, how natural my hair looks.
New Vitalis Superhold. It looks natural and holds longer.
Don Chaney was not injured. It was a strategy timeout, something he did not see and like. When the bullets came down the floor, he called it, went over and talked to head coach Tommy Heinsohn.
It could mean that in a situation like that, the reason he called that timeout, they ran a play they weren't accustomed to seeing before. He did something that he doesn't ordinarily do.
Nelson, the basketball. Hayes stays with Collins. Nelson takes the shot.
You see that? What patience he had that time. He waited for the cutter. No one was home. He turned and looked and knocked it in.
Tied at 12. First quarter in the Boston Garden. Unsell wheels to rear. Shanier trying to stay low with Chaney.
Hey, what a move that time. I say he's got his confidence going for him now.
Oh, White gets past Porter. Can't hit it. Pulled down by Hondo.
I think John got bucked a little bit that time. Well, Richie Ross Hodges tells him to keep his feet.
That will be very difficult for one Tommy Heinsohn, let me tell you.
I look for some technical fouls in this game today, Brett.
Tied at 14. Hold it, whistle underneath. Hayes and Collins, it's on Dave. That's his second foul.
They cannot afford to let that guy get into foul trouble. And here comes Paul Silas, number six man on the team. This guy's been very instrumental in their success over the years. The other guy's Paul Westfall, who should be in this game soon. Now, Silas will go to Hayes. And Collins will switch over to Unsell.
Hayes shoots against Silas. Collins battling Unsell. Loose ball foul against Unsell. His first.
And West doesn't like that. That was a good box out that time by Collins. He got Unsell out of there and he got the ball. Got a foul out of it, I should say. Chaney good boxing.
Gives to White and they crisscross. Here's Havlicek. Rudin will stay on him. Two players similar in style. They go inside to Silas. Silas drives.
Oh! You know, that's the way you come into a ball game. Go back.
JoJo White. Bullets dropping back extremely well on defense.
Yes, sir.
Chaney. Oh. Rebound, Elvin Hayes. They'll try to run it, but it's over here and it's heading out of bounds.
Now, this has been Boston so tough because they try to really take advantage of all of your mistakes. They got to play out now. Number 22, I believe. Okay, here we start.
Silas to Cowan. Unsell pulls it down. And now it is the Celtics back in a hurry on defense. They make that transition so well, these two teams. Rudin. Off the front of the rim. Here they have the check. It's 3-on-2, 4-on-2. It's a 4-point Boston lead as Porter brings it up for the Bullets.
Elton did a great job that time waiting for him to get set in the corner. That lane knocked it right in.
Chaney misses. Collins rebound. Off to JoJo White. Celtics trying to bring it to him right now. Havlicek with the basketball. Gives to Collins. Collins waits for Chaney. Chaney to Havlicek. They work the lead. Taken over by Porter.
Yes, it was.
It'll be a 2-point Boston lead.
You know what Boston is doing right now? They're opening it up a little bit, keeping the middle open, working outside, trying to get down the lane.
There's something out on the floor right behind David Collins, who passes the ball to Chaney. Richard Powers doesn't see it. Chaney comes up with a shot. It's a 4-point Celtic lead. Porter brings it back down. Here's Chenier. Kevin Porter inside to Wesley Unseld.
Yeah, they're going to try to get Collins out of this ball game.
Moving against Collins. Turn around. Collins with a rebound. They still have that object on the floor with somebody to kick it off. There, Richie Powers has got it. JoJo White.
Yeah. Richie Powers gets the object, and JoJo White gets the basket. And Washington wants to... Let's see what they're going to do now. They want a timeout. Yep.
Listen to this crowd in the Boston Garden. It is jam-packed for game one of this Eastern Conference Final between the Celtics and the Washington Bullets. And right now, it is a streak that the Celtics are putting on, and they have opened up a slight lead.
Yeah, as I said a moment ago, they're very tough when you make mistakes against them. They come down, they get a good shot, and they got some good shooters, and they use it and put it in the basket.
Next Saturday and Sunday afternoons, CBS will continue its coverage of the NBA playoffs with a game from each of the conference final series. Now in the West, it will be Golden State versus Chicago, and in the Eastern Finals, Washington, of course, versus Boston again. Now our Saturday telecast will begin at 3 p.m. Eastern time, and on Sunday afternoon, the tip-off will be 1 p.m. Eastern time, and you'll see both games next weekend on CBS. That Golden State-Chicago series will begin tonight out on the West Coast. Golden State has the home court advantage in that series. They wound up with a better regular season record. As you take a look at Phil Chenier sitting on the Washington bench, now we switch over to Tommy Heinsohn's huddle. Oscar, so far I have been impressed with the way the Bullets have made that transition from offense to defense. There was one fast break opportunity. Chaney cashed in on it. Chaney has scored 10 points here in the first quarter. He's a high point man. He is 5 of 5. In the playoffs, he is averaging 15 points a game. Of course, that was against Houston. That is about 7 points higher than his regular season average.
Yeah, I think when you come into the playoffs, you try to get some defensive strategy that's going to work for you, and they're trying to sacrifice a little bit. I let in Chaney shoot, but it's not working for Washington. They got to go out and play it.
The Bullets trailing by 6 points. Chenier has Chaney on him in this situation, and White is picking up Kevin Porter. They'll switch these guards around a lot. Elvin Hayes has Silas now watching him. They come to Reardon, and Havlicek is there. Chenier trying to maneuver, has to come back outside. Shot clock getting down to one. Hayes gets it up. Reardon hits
Reardon
the offensive
gets the rebound.
Board and recycles. There's Chenier. Not there. They missed twice, and they got it again.
And the Big E comes home with it.
You can't give Washington or Boston three opportunities.
That's true. They should have boxed out Reardon when he got the first rebound. It didn't. They get a basket.
Right there. Hayes tries to steal it from Collins. No foul. Heinsohn one-on-one. Collins with a shot. Not there. Ball goes out of bounds. Belongs to Washington. Heinsohn complaining to Manny Sokol that they should have called a foul on Elvin Hayes.
I think so. That's what he's complaining about, I should say.
Here's Porter on himself. Collins now on him. Collins with two fouls here in the first quarter. White watching Porter. They go to Chenier. Chenier has Collins. They go back to Unseld. Knocked away by Chaney. Here comes Silas.
Yes,
Silas right down the middle. He's got... Well, again, it's that Washington defense doing the job. And it's White at the perimeter. Not there, and there was a foul. Loose ball. It's on Wes Unseld. His second.
Loose ball foul on Wesley Unseld that time, but...
Three team fouls against Washington, two against Boston. Neither team yet in the penalty situation. Silas and Chaney play catch. Here's Silas, makes a move on Unseld, passes to Hondo. Havlicek with his own rebound. Still misses. Here lets it go out because the ball belongs to Washington. 1:55 left in the first quarter. Kevin Porter controlling it to the Bullets, goes to Elvin Hayes. Hayes waits for Reardon to come back out.
That's it.
Now they're going to pull. Oh, Hayes is all alone. He knocks it for layup.
Oh, he finally gets it in. It should have been over that time. You know what Washington has done in this game? They just twist the offense from the right-hand side of the court over to the left, bringing Hayes up so he gets some movement over there instead of letting him wait down at the pivot and post up and trying to get the ball in that way.
Boston leading by a field goal as Silas goes to the hoop, then Hayes comes up with a block. Kevin Porter comes out of there.
Good defense by the Big E. Big E's in there now.
Stutter step. Olaj turned it over, said Richie Powers.
Watch this play right here. They don't pick up the Big E, and he goes up. He misses. They thought he was going to hit that shot. I think Silas did. Sort of relaxed a little bit, so he gets a second try and gets it in.
Rookie Glenn McDonald has checked in, and Havlicek has gone to the Boston bench. Celtics leading by a field goal. JoJo White makes it four.
He is really tough in that spot. They can't afford to let him get those shots off that pick because he can kill you.
Minute left in the first quarter. Phil Chenier outside. He's got it, says Richie Powers, and he was fouled.
And against Buffalo, he had a little shooting problem in the last final game there, the seventh game, that is. He sort of straightened out, and he's really looking good right now. He goes up. He extends out very well. Patient. Bam.
So Chaney has one foul. Chenier can't convert it into a point. Down comes Don Chaney. 24-22. JoJo White forced back out. Double team. Cowan. Elvin Hayes, that's his first.
Big E got out of position. Dave took advantage of it and rolled the ball up and got a foul out of it. Here, you know, Dave just tried to reverse pivot, and Hayes got his body into him, trying to do something to keep him from getting that basket, but gets the first free throw out of it.
3-point Celtic lead with that free throw, and Nick Weatherspoon has checked into the game.
And the people are not booing, they're saying spoon.
Don Nelson will check back in for Tommy Heisen. Owens can make it a 4-point lead, he does. That's the time left in the first period here in the Boston Garden. Quarter goes to Nick Weatherspoon. Donald is on him. Now they go to Elvin Hayes. A battle, Silas Spoon, good rebound here, knocked away and fouled by McDonald.
Well, Weatherspoon really goes tough to those boards.
Don't get up again.
You see him right here, battle Silas, gets the ball and gets fouled by McDonald.
He is like a knife when he cuts through those big guys and pulls that board back down out of there. There's a player who was shooting only 30% during the first half of the regular season, closed out at 52%.
That's a good turnaround. Well, they're missing their free throws right now. They need to convert these. Well, I get another. Get the bonus shot now.
Cut Boston's lead to one field goal, but he doesn't hit it.
No,
this
he doesn't.
Two or three. With the ball. They can play it. Olaj, says Powers.
Well, JoJo doesn't like that.
He was called on the offense.
And now it's Washington's turn to come down and get one shot with 14 seconds left.
They trail it by 3 points. Last shot for the quarter coming up. Chenier puts a move on Chaney. Now turns around the other side. Left-handed shot. There's a whistle. Offensive foul.
Well, Chenier, he doesn't say anything about that.
The Celtics will have 5 seconds.
Yes, they will.
And they want Westfall in the game to take this shot.
Well, I don't know why you should take out Don Chaney. I don't think he's missed it, has he?
Westfall has a little better range. Maybe they're going to try to get him outside here, oh. Well, it's JoJo who's going to take it. Well, that was an interesting substitution.
No, I think why he did that really is that West is going to stay in the ball game anyway, and so he gets a good shoot into the game. So therefore, when the quarter comes back for the second quarter, they'll leave West in the game for Don Chaney.
All right, we're at the end of one quarter.
You see the best in basketball when you watch the NBA. When you watch the NBA on CBS.
Way back in my mind, I had an idea of going to a car with that had a rebate to it. But then again, I kept coming back to gas mileage, performance, looks. That's why my wife and I purchased the Datsun. I thought we'd get more value out of a Datsun than we would a rebate.
Why not join the thousands of value-conscious new Datsun owners? Only Datsun offers a choice of three cars that get 39 miles per gallon.
This lone, self-propelled Eager One is attempting to cut every blade of grass in Lanesville, Indiana. It's a small town, but it's mostly quarter-acre lots. Eager One starts first time almost every time, and its self-propelled drive really cuts work. We accidentally hit this buried object and had to replace a crankshaft, but the same Eager One finished the job. Here's the result, as much grass as you'd probably cut in years. Craftsman Eager One, eager to start, eager to finish.
When they asked me to try light beer from Miller, I was at first reluctant to do so. Then my distinguished colleague, Lodge Lewis, urged me to try it, so I tried it. And I discovered that light is indeed less filling because it contains less carbohydrates and one-third less calories than their regular beer. I observed further that light truly tastes great. All right, Louis, drop the beer.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less.
17 times in the last 19 years, the Boston Celtics have been involved in the Eastern Finals of the NBA. 12 times they have won world championships. Here in game one against Washington, they have a three-point lead as we prepare to start the second quarter. Manny Sokol throws it up, and it's controlled by White, who took it away from Porter, and here's Westfall, who stays in the game. Powell gazes on him. John Nelson. Goes to JoJo White. Washington playing tremendous team defense. Foul from the ball against Witherspoon. That's the first one against Spoon. He'd switched off on Cowens and he was pushing him. Powers picked it up underneath. JoJo White with the basketball. They go to Don Nelson. Knocked back by Silas. Westfall hits it to Chenier. Down come the bullets. Boom! Breaking and just letting too much.
Well, I think he should have given the ball to Porter right away then. There's too much traffic in front of Witherspoon, and it's been a difficult pass. Threw it out of bounds.
Westfall. Here comes the right side.
This play should go into Davey now. Play number six.
Hayes knows it. He's all over him, Mo. There it is. Turn around. Battle underneath, Unseld controls it. West has not yet scored a point for Washington. Here's Kevin Porter.
They're going to set it up again.
Unseld picks on White. Porter gets inside.
Oh, that. Hey, I talked to Casey before the game. He said if Kevin can penetrate three situations, they're going to be tough. And he did that time, got in and made a basket.
White back on Porter, baseline left.
Big guy should have picked him up that time. They didn't, so he got into the basketball layup. Good drive. Very good drive.
3-point Celtic lead. Porter with the ball. Gives to Witherspoon. Don Nelson on him. In and out. Silas boards it. Out to Nelson, and again, look at that Washington defense. No easy hoops here for the Celtics. They've had to work in this game. Silas back to Collins outside.
Mr. Inside and Mr. Outside. Dave Cowens can really do it all.
They have taken away their fast break so far, and still Boston leads it by five. Here's Kevin Porter on serve. Silas doing a good job on Elvin Hayes since he's come in. Witherspoon. Silas yanks it down. Westfall trying to get something going. Chenier was there. Porter there on him. Now they go back to JoJo White. Nelson, great shooter, goes back to Cowens.
Hey, great pick and roll that time by Dave and Nelson.
That's 8 points for Collins. Jimmy Jones is going to check in. Mike Reardon will get back in. Casey's going to make some substitutions. Look at Silas lean on Elvin. He's got it off.
He's doing it good. That guy, when he starts to jump up there, he just completely out-jumps those defenders.
A 5-point Boston lead. White would move on Porter. Hold on, there's a whistle blown underneath by Sokol. He's got Kevin Porter, who was holding up against JoJo White. That's the first foul of this game against Porter.
See some of the action right here now. They're just standing around waiting for things. Whoop, a little action going, a little elbow. A little touch among friends.
Thank you.
Scirocco! Scirocco!
Scirocco, a hot wind from the Sahara. Scirocco, a hot car from Volkswagen. As swift and powerful as the wind it's named after. Scirocco, with front-wheel drive that handles like nothing you've ever driven before. And Scirocco gets about 38 miles per gallon on the highway. Scirocco, the hot one from Volkswagen.
Sometimes it seems like the fun of family travel doesn't really start till you stop traveling.
You get that holiday feeling at Holiday Inn. A warm and friendly feeling the minute you walk in. Get that holiday feeling, that holiday feeling, that holiday feeling.
And you can charge everything on the American Express card.
At Holiday Inn.
Next Sunday afternoon on the CBS Sports Spectacular, we will have the Mixed Doubles Classic from Phoenix, Arizona. Oscar, when I was watching Tony Travert and Pat Summerall describe the Connors Newcomb showdown, I heard Travert mention that he would be out there and that Billie Jean King would be his partner in that event, and it will be on 3:30 p.m. Eastern Time on CBS.
Yeah, this will make a dynamite duo.
Hey, that Jimmy Connors can play tennis.
Hey, he is really tough. Hits so hard, so often, and so long.
I'll tell you what, he's been out to Las Vegas twice this year, and he's come away a winner both times, and there aren't many who can say that.
And that was not at the gambling tables either.
We don't know about that. Westfall with a pass to Silas. It is 32-27, 9:29 for the half. The Celtics with the lead.
I know that coaches are matching up now. Reardon's back in the game to guard Havlicek.
We're back to Collins, and here's JoJo White. Silas, and he was fouled by Jimmy Jones when he went back up.
One second.
See the shot right here. Silas gets inside a little 40. And Jones hit him on the arm.
Tommy wanted another call. There's Collins going to Silas. Silas waits for White. In and out, and Unsel pulls it down, and they go to Reardon.
Yep. Stuff underneath. He hasn't scored yet, but they're going to need a little score from everybody today.
Jones and Reardon playing catch. Westfall picks up Jones. Chenier is getting ready to check back in. So is Cheney. Here's Kevin Porter. Porter goes to Elvin Hayes. Hayes fronts Silas. Hits.
Wow, he's backing that ball in very good.
Jones was coming up like he might try to steal it from Westfall, but Paul got it up for the Celtics. It is a three-point Boston lead right now. Westfall against Jones. Here's White. That time, JoJo got closer to the hoop.
Well, listen, what they're trying to do now, get some situations where they actually look for it inside. I'm sure Chenier's going to be back into the ball game pretty soon. But they can't afford to let that happen too often.
Unsel gives it back to Porter. White is watching him. Kevin trying to maneuver. Outside, Unsel hits Hayes again. Knocked away to Westfall. Porter and Unsel back on defense. They go to JoJo White. 7-point Boston lead. 7:55 for the half.
When they break, Brent, they're really tough to beat.
Hayes to Reardon. Reardon comes right side, Jones. Jones waits. Silas picks off Hayes. He can't get over to that side. Jones. This time there is a foul. Loose ball. It's on Silas.
Yep.
That's his first. Cheney and Chenier are checking back in. White will take a break. And Kevin Porter goes over and sits down.
Yeah, you can see a big view from the top of the arena here. They need to get Porter out in that situation because they started taking him underneath the basket. And he's just not that tough. He's not tall enough to guard some guys underneath the basket.
Here's Chenier double team, leaving somebody open. Bad pass.
Well, I don't know if it was bad or not, Brent. I think the West should have been rolling that time, but the turnover.
Taken down by Hayes, who comes out, and Havlicek is off his foot.
It's off of Havlicek's foot that time. Great run back, but that time by Havlicek getting back on defense, because if he hadn't been there, they'd have had 2 points.
Oh, does Russ have to roll automatically in that situation?
Well, that's up to him. I think in that situation where two defenders switch off on him, he should have stepped to the basket a little bit.
Jimmy Jones.
Oh, Jimmy Jones gets it right in.
Cheney bringing it down for the Celtics. They lead 5 points, 7 minutes for the half. Cheney back to Havlicek. Chenier and Reardon double dribble.
He double dribble.
foul, says Manny Sokol.
Well, I thought he double dribbled myself. They call him for an offensive foul.
Jimmy Jones calls off the play. They go to rim, back to Jones. Jones at the free throw line. Here's Havlicek. It's going to be short.
Yeah.
Collins controls it, and here comes Westfall. Westfall on the right side.
I don't know if the people at home can pick that up or not, but Salas had a great pick on Wesley's man, and he didn't disappoint him. He knocked it in for him.
Foul called by Richie Powers. It's against the Washington Bullets. And we're going to have a timeout called. You can take a look at that pick that Oscar was talking about. Did you see that?
Yeah, great pick that time at Salas. West goes up off his feet. Westy knocked it in.
So it's 38-31. 6:33 for the half.
I guess I'm just crazy about cars. I've been hanging around them for years. And with all the punishment they have to take, a helpful hint couldn't hurt. STP, oil treatment for your car. You add it to the crankcase when your oil is changed and the first time your oil is down. STP helps protect your engine from friction and wear better than all without STP. Take it from a girl who knows. STP, it helps your oil do a better job.
Well, you see, I didn't go to college, but I wanted to make sure the kids could if I wasn't around. So I called Allstate for some life insurance.
John Vesio bought $50,000 of our 30-year decreasing-term life insurance. Just $14 a month at age 27. It'll help his kids go to college if he's not around. How about yours? Call and check Allstate's low rates.
You know, Allstate gave me a lot of life insurance and the price was right. That's what sold me.
America's finest amateur athletes have begun their preparation for the greatest of international sports competitions, the Olympics, to be held in 76 in Innsbruck and Montreal. And your help and financial support are important to them. If you would like to support our Olympic team, send a $5 contribution to the U.S. Olympic Committee, Box 1000C, Cathedral Station, Boston, Massachusetts. Our athletes will appreciate your help. Oh, that battle under the boards. Hayes and Unsell have pulled down 9 rebounds. Cowens and Silas have 8.
Yeah, there's some tough people underneath, but in a game like this, when you have such great rebounders, they're going to be boxing out a lot more than they would in an ordinary basketball game. A lot of things are going to happen. The ball's going to be knocked loose a lot, so they got to scramble for it.
Celtics with a 7-point lead. Silas makes it 9.
Well, I'm sure Uncle didn't expect that to happen, but it's 2 points.
Now it is the biggest lead of the game. They go to work. He misses. Collins pulls it down into traffic. Reardon will take it away. He should not have thrown at. Havlicek was double-teamed. Back comes Reardon. Reardon goes to Jones. Jones now maneuvers over to the left side. Gets Westfall. Comes down on him. Olan. He was not fouled.
Is it traveling?
He has turned it over.
I think he called traveling.
Back in. It was a traveling call. Bounce pass to Silas. Silas to the left side. There's Westfall. Good shooter for this time. Not this time, and Hayes yanks it down.
Wow.
And comes to Jones.
He got up in there then.
So far, it has been a cat and mouse game between these two teams, both countering, particularly the coaches. Elvin Hayes on the turnaround.
He hasn't missed that bank shot yet.
7-point Celtic lead. Westfall has it down. JoJo White is up. He'll check in. Talk about substitution so far. Westfall comes back outside. Cheney's there. Not this time. Havlicek with another offensive board. Comes right back up on Witherspoon. That's on Elvin Hayes and not Witherspoon, and that's his third. Hayes is arguing with Powers.
He's the captain, not you. 2 shots.
Hey, you know, he could be right. That did look like Witherspoon to me.
I thought Nick was right there that time on him as Havlicek comes to the line.
Well, anyway, John will get 2 free throws. That was a smart play by John, then. He gets the defender off his feet, gets hit, so he shoots. Smart play. Because I thought that was Witherspoon.
It's a 9-point Boston lead. Unseld goes to Jones. Chaney here with a little contact. And Chaney comes back over the top of Jones and fouls him.
That was a bad foul. I guess Don didn't really expect him to back up into him that time. And he got a little too close, too much contact.
Two fouls on Chaney. Two fouls on Collins. Three fouls on Elvin Hayes. 9-point game. There's a whistle on it. It's on JoJo White on the hold against Witherspoon. That's his second. And the fourth on the team. Both teams now in the penalty with 4:58 to go in the first half. Shanier's inside. Collins
couldn't deny the big red ass that time. He went up and got that and pulled it down.
They can build an 11-point lead if they can hit here. Havlicek, Chaney saves it, goes back to Hondo. They go to JoJo White. One shot, circle.
That was on Shanier.
That's his second.
And they're in the bonus.
Celtic lead. 4:35 to go in the first half. Jimmy Jones brings it up for the bullets until White is on him. They go to West Sun. Now back to Shanier, but no, hold on. Richie Powell blew the whistle, and it's on Chaney.
And they'll be in the bonus this time, I believe. That was a good play. Set that play up very well that time. They changed it up just a little bit. You can see West, it's a quick action play. The play comes from West Sun. So what Shanier has to do, he's got to hold Chaney outside just for a second or two. Let that play develop to him. Also can get the ball to make the pass.
Free throw is important now as Washington tries to get back.
Chaney's out of the ball game now. In comes Nelson, which means Havlicek will go into the backcourt. Which won't hurt the team in at all.
And here comes Havlicek, bringing the ball up as a guard. Shanier awaits it. Jones is on White. Hayes has Collins. Silas has the basketball. Nothing can happen until he decides it. Havlicek.
Good play that time by Havlicek. He kept moving.
So in his first play as a guard in this game, he has burned the bullets. And the Celtics go back on top by 10. 4 minutes for the half. Spoon holds on. Nelson backs off. Now he comes up with his right hand on him. With his Spoon maneuvers up in the air.
Yeah, gets it in. There's a lot of hand-checking going on in this game.
White. Spoon with a rebound after scoring that hoop. Gives it to Shanier. Jones working in the backcourt.
I notice that Washington seems to be patient. They seem to want to walk the ball down in situations.
Havlicek come down to go for it. Shanier got back very well on Collins. White's the trailer. They go back to Hondo. It's 10 points, and what a pretty play.
And the defense is doing a job for the Celtics so far. They're still involved in creating situations, getting the break started. And they're up 10 points.
3:15 for Washington. They go to Witherspoon. It's off his knee, but Havlicek fouled him, and Hondo knew it.
Notice how quick they switch on defense. When there's a call, they jump right out and attack the offense. They don't wait and sit back like a lot of teams.
Two fouls against Havlicek. And, of course, because they're in the penalty, Spoon will come to the line.
101. Two shots. Good.
Seven. That takes them a long time. It's a timeout.
Now a timeout is called. You heard Richie Powers. He picked up the call by Casey Jones, Washington bench.
Here comes the play. Jones played it very well against JoJo that time. From Hondo. Nice basket right into the hoop.
kid.
Gotta get on up, gotta make a move, gotta get on up. Baby, pick me up.
Yeah, they're springing, they get me on up there. But what I really like is the protection and the support they give you. Because after you get up there, you've got to come down.
But you let me down.
But you let me down easy.
Down easy.
You let me down easy. Down
easy.
You let me down easy.
Sure you do. That's the one you get it on with when you drive the new Volkswagen Rabbit with all the big engineering hits of the season.
Such breakthroughs as front-wheel drive. 38 miles to the gallon on the highway, baby. Big hatchback at no extra charge. You'll dig room galore, plus security blanket and many, many more. So come on, act now, get down, get in. Take a rabbit for a spin.
This is John Havlicek. Using that timeout to pretty herself up, she's sitting next to JoJo White's wife on her right-hand side, or on her left, right as you look at the screen. This is Henry Finkel. The wives in a conversation discussing what they're going to do should they win this title with all that money.
And Mrs. Salas and Mrs. Finkel, right? If we can all get this all straight. We don't want to get the guy with the wrong wife.
Were there any girlfriends over there?
Oh, Brent. I'll leave that one alone.
Well, I mean for the single player.
Oh,
well, you know, it's all right for them to go out.
Who's single?
It's an 8-point lead as JoJo White brings it back. Hondo has a check for the ball. It goes to Don Nelson into Collins.
What's going down?
Waits for White. Bounce back to Havlicek. They wheel to Silas. Silas comes out. Oh, great ball movement.
Yes, it was. You know what they do to teams? They keep moving. Teams think a certain guy's going to shoot the ball. He's covered. Boom, right to the open man to Havlicek that time.
Good pass. Here's Chenier. Knocked away by Collins. Unseld retrieves it deep in that right corner. Havlicek has him. Nelson's on Witherspoon. Boom with the ball, and there's a whistle. Turned it over again. Washington has turned the ball over 12 times to Boston's 4 in the first half.
They can run that same play again.
Collins with the basketball. Elvin Hayes with the left hand on him. Here's JoJo White. Nelson. Jones yanks it down. We've got 2:13 for the half.
But you notice that Boston's one of the few teams that will swing that ball back to the weak side. Weak side, I mean, the action's all on the right. Back to town to Nelson. Took a shot, but he missed it.
Hayes on the turnaround.
Wow, that guy is really tough so far. He hasn't missed that shot yet.
He has 16 points. He's keeping Washington in this game. They trail it by 8. It's 1:53 for the half. Havlicek goes back after it. Now the pass to Nelson. Collins tried to tip it back in. Silas has an offensive rebound. Oh, go, and here's Chenier.
Here they come on a break now.
Jones, Chenier behind his back. Loses control. Loose ball. The Celtics will pick it up at Havlicek. Havlicek to White.
Well, that was a bad pass by Chenier then. He didn't need to do that.
Collins. Spooner and Hayes. Washington can't do anything right.
No, they can't right now. Boy, the Celtics really put the pressure on you. They create a lot of situations. Here they go fighting the ball. Witherspoon didn't know Elvin had his hands on it, then he knocked it out of bounds.
Oscar, I think it's a letdown after that tough seven-game series. I think Washington is yet back in the groove for this one. Here's Havlicek. Collins on the roll.
Great play that time by two great athletes, Dave Collins and John Havlicek.
The second half is going to be different. Washington is not ready.
Not yet. They need to talk about something. I don't know what they're going to talk about.
There's Hayes. He's got 16, and he's got Havlicek and Silas double-teaming him. He goes up. He misses Silas.
Well, he should have passed that ball out to Chenier that time. He was wide open. I think he wanted Chenier to cut to the basket, but he didn't, and he missed the shot.
Collins goes to Nelson. Right. Gets inside.
Oh, hey, they're really going to town now.
It is a 12-point Boston lead. 40 seconds for the half. Hayes.
Yep, he's fouled by Havlicek that time.
Hondo is coming in behind him, and that's his third foul.
Here's a pick set up by Dave that time. And Vicky was just back too far. Then he makes a mistake. He goes out. The redhead's in for 2 points.
Paul Westphal is going to check into this game. So with three fouls, Havlicek will go out. He played very well at guard.
Extremely well at guard.
...17 points for the Big E. ...18 points. And it's a 10-point Celtic lead. They have 36 seconds. They cannot use up the time completely.
Well, what they'll walk it down, they'll get a good shot. If they get something, a good jumper here, I'm sure they'll take it. But they're going to work the ball, try to get down and get something good.
Nelson has been getting open on Witherspoon. We'll see what happens here. Spoon is on him very tightly. Nelson has the ball. They go to Collins. He's yeah. there. Collins loses it, gets it back. Turn around, not there. Nelson knocked away by Eve.
Oh, he got hit that
Ten
time.
Seconds. 9 seconds. This crowd didn't like it. No whistle. They go to Witherspoon. Hayes is open. Now Collins is there. Hayes turns around. Not there. Spoon was driving in. Loose ball foul. Call by Matty Sokol. And it was on Witherspoon, I believe, when he went back up in the air. We'll get that straightened out.
I'll tell you.
So it was a backcourt, which means Silas is going to come up here behind.
It's a loose ball foul. He'll get a bonus this time. And Paul is there. But I think Nelson really got knocked down by the Big E that time, but nothing was called.
Paul Silas hits both the free throws. The action was wild there in the closing moments of the first half. We can take a look at that play.
Now Nelson gets a rebound right here. We'll see it. Got a good angle. His leg caught him a little bit.
I think Elvin went up very well on that, but we're at halftime at the Boston Garden. It is 55-43.
You'll see the best in basketball when you watch the NBA. When you watch the NBA on CBS.
Hey, Schick takes the stick out.
Schick takes the stick out.
Schick takes the stick out of shaving with smoother, close-shaving Teflon-coated blades. Look, a straight razor has no Teflon, so it can stick before cutting. But Schick Injector with Teflon cuts cleaner with 39% less pull. Schick Injector with exclusive Teflon. Now on Injector Twin Blades, too. Schick takes the stick out.
For smoother, close shaves.
Some people, they don't mean to waste gas. But the Champion Spark Plug Company has found that if your car has gone over 10,000 miles without a tune-up, chances are you're wasting 1 to 2 gallons of gas in every tankful. You might as well pour it on the ground. 1 to 2 gallons, completely wasted. So please, keep your car tuned up. And remember, when you tune it up, we've got your plug.
I'm John Havlicek, and I'm 6 feet 5 inches.
You're trying to reach the rim, okay?
Jonathan Hadley is 4 feet 2 inches, but we're both part of the new NBA Special Olympics basketball program for mentally retarded youngsters. I'm a coach, and Jonathan's learning very fast. Right, Jonathan?
All right.
For information on playing or coaching, please write Special Olympics, Washington, D.C.
As the basketball season heads for its championship series, baseball's year is just getting underway, but already a question is puzzling the American League. What happened to the man with the world on the million-dollar string? Catfish Hunter had everything going for him, youth, money, and an impressive ERA, but things have not been working out, as Ken Squire reports.
I think he'll come around, but I hope it's soon because a lot of fans are unhappy, I'm sure of it. $3 million is a lot of money to pay if someone's not going to win any games.
New York press, a lot of pressure. Yeah, you expect a lot. He'll come around.
No man's got that money. Too much money.
Too much money.
It's too much for any ball player.
That ball player, Jim Catfish Hunter, capped a 25-game win season, yet another sparkling, victorious World Series, and the Cy Young Award with deliverance from what some have called Charlie Finley's bondage.
Mm-hmm.
out of Oakland to the New York Yankees as the cure-all for whatever ailed them. But in the season's first 3 weeks, the magic multi-million dollar elixir has yet to take effect. And the Yankees this past week found themselves still at the bottom of the American League East. Friday night, while the Yankees waited on rainy weather to start their Milwaukee series, we asked catcher Thurman Munson about the fan criticism which has clouded Hunter's debut.
You know, you really can't worry about New York fans because if you hit a home run, then you strike out the next time they boo you. So, you know, they're quick to forget. There's a lot of ball clubs around here, and, you know, they want to win it real bad. And I think especially in Shea Stadium, because Shea Stadium's the National League ballpark. You know, Brooklyn Dodgers were out here, and now the Mets. And really, I think some fans come out to see them do bad. Just because it's a National League area.
They're good fans. They're good baseball fans, and they like to come to ballpark, and they like to express their opinion. Catfish is in a situation that everybody knows about him and has read about him, and they expect quite a bit out of him, and I think he'll give them that before the year's over.
You expect him to still win 20 games?
Very definitely.
Last year at the All-Star break, I think he was 9-8 or 10-8. After that, he, I think, was 16-4. Something close to that. I know he won 25 games, and I found out he has been a slow starter. And this year, the first three games he pitched, was really cold weather, and but it was no excuse. Up in Boston recently, he had a real nice warm day, and we got a lot of runs for him, and he feels as bad about it as anybody. And I think the whole team was just pulling so hard from up in Boston Wednesday to win that game. And I think once he wins his first one, he's just going to take off, and he's the type of pitcher could win 8 or 10 games in a row for you.
It's just 3 weeks into the season. Are you sick of the press already?
I was sick of that this winter before the season even started, and now I'm seeing like it everywhere I go, they're there.
Doesn't seem to make much difference. 2 years ago and 3 years ago, season started the same way, and there was a little bit of a flap, but not one like this year.
Well, I think this year it's been a little tougher. You know, everybody expected me to win right away, expected me to win 100 games in one season. But it's tough on me, and it's tough on the rest of the team playing behind me because they want to win so bad for me.
Other years, you've had a little spell when it's been 3 or 4 games, and it comes back up to 25 and 21 games. Are you more concerned now?
Well, I'm concerned about it. I want to win because that's the reason I'm playing baseball to win, and I'm playing because the Yankees paid me the money to play. And, you know, that's the only way I know how to play, is to win.
How about New York? Does that take some getting used to?
Well, a little bit, not that much. I think the fans here in New York noticed things more than the fans did in Oakland. Fans in Oakland, they were there, they cheered for you, but they didn't notice every little thing. In New York, they notice everything. How you dress, how you look, how late you stay up, how much you drink, everything.
If you had your druthers, how would you take time off in a place like New York City?
Well, I'd live outside of town, you know, and I'd probably go fishing. I'd go something out in the country, riding, anything just to get out where there's nature, where there's grass, where there's trees.
The eventual rainout did not provide Catfish any grass or trees, but perhaps it gave him a moment to reflect on the price he'll have to pay to pitch in tough little old New York. So although New York hopes have been dampened a little bit by Catfish's shallow start, it's not really considered serious as yet. But come the midst of May, if he's 0-6 or 0-7, then the pristine beauty of Catfish's Shea Stadium Goldfish Bowl could become very murky indeed. And if it continued, he might very well want to be on one of these jets that shuffles on by every minute or so at Shea Stadium. Ken Squire for CBS Sports.
NBA playoffs will continue after this word from your local station. Danny Kaye proves that opera can be fun with his guests, Beverly Sills and Robert Merrill, later today on CBS.
Hello there. May I be blunt? Flying in the USA, I find it difficult to tell one airline from another.
But that's all been changed, you see. TWA introduces Trans World Service, which gives one a taste of Europe whilst flying in the USA.
You'll enjoy wines of the world over Washington. Continental cuisine over Colorado. Quiche Lorraine. Lovely fish and chips. Lasagna over Los Angeles. You'll hear Mozart over Missouri. You'll see foreign films over Phoenix. Great footage, Carlo. Excitingly underexposed. So ask your travel agent about Transworld Service and get a taste of Europe at 30,000 feet, what? Keep in touch. Taste of
USA, Channel 2, New York.
Back at halftime at the Boston Garden, where the Celtics are leading the Washington Bullets 55-43 in the first game of their Eastern Conference Final. Sonny Hill is back here at our CBS announce booth with us. And Sonny, I did want to cover the Mindy Rudolph story first, because as many of you know, and perhaps some of you don't know, Friday night in the seventh game of that series between Washington and Buffalo, Mindy collapsed and he was hospitalized. Doctors tell us he is in fair condition down there, and the hospital has asked that all of Mindy's friends please don't call the hospital, because no one can talk to him right now. Sonny, you were down there, and I'll tell you, it was one of the most frightening situations I have ever seen. And had it not been for the Washington trainer Bill Ford and Dr. Levine to offer assistance to Mindy Rudolph, I'm told that there is a chance that he could have died right there on the court. He was starting to swallow his tongue when they got to him.
It was a very touching situation. I was sitting at scorer's row, and I had a seat to see the whole situation. And the real thing that was significant about that was the way that Mindy Rudolph was so concerned about the game, even with the fact that his health was endangered, maybe even his life. He took time out, walked off the floor, and then paused and called the two coaches over and apologized to them because he couldn't go on and be involved in the ball game. And I think that speaks well, not only for Mindy Rudolph, but the officials all over the country, and it shows how involved they are in the sport of basketball.
All right, now let's talk a bit about the first half. You have to be awfully disappointed in Washington's performance.
Well, I would say that the defense on the part of Celtics was very strong. I thought Oscar used a very good description when he said that the Celtics were attacking the Washington Bullet Ball Club as they came down the floor. So in the first half, it was a situation of the Celtic team defense dominating the Washington Bullet offense.
Well, you have been back picking out some highlights, so we can take a look at some of the action in the first half. But Elvin Hayes has been a one-man scoring machine for the Bullets. Without him, there wouldn't be any place.
Right. He's the player who has really held the Washington Bullets in the ball game. Here's a fast break, and the Celtics did not have a lot of fast breaks, but this shows how the Celtics run the fast break. Havlicek with a beautiful pass to Don Chaney for a slam dunk. Here's a steal. Kevin Porter was very instrumental in holding the Bullets together to some degree as he stole the ball away from Havlicek. And Havlicek was having some problems in the first half when he was guarded by Mike Reardon. And here's a player who had 5 for 5 in the first half of the ball game, Don Chaney. And when you get that kind of offense out of him, that's good. Here's a good play. Hayes misses the dunk, but he goes right back and banks in a layup. And here's a play away from the ball, a give and go, and the Celtics are noted for their kind of play of going without the ball and receiving the pass. And here's a good play again. Hayes, as you said, was very instrumental in holding the Washington Bullets in the ball game with a back jump shot over Silas, who played in most of the first half of the ball game because of the foul situation on Cowens. And here's a fast break again, and it's Westfall coming off the bench, and he finds the open man, and that's JoJo White, and he had a very good first half. And here's a classic Celtic play. Havlicek, and that's the pick and roll, and instinctively he realizes that the men are coming over to him, and then he drops the ball off to Cowens, and he goes in for an unmolested layup.
Sonny, why was John Havlicek more effective as a guard than as a forward in that first half?
John feels that he gets in the game a lot more as a guard. He can bring the ball to the floor. He can create situations. Mike Reardon does an excellent job of defending him, and he keeps him away from the ball. And throughout the first half, when Mike Reardon was in the ball game, Havlicek did not have any success offensively. So Heinsohn, being the smart coach that he is, switched him to the backcourt, and then he started getting involved in the offense, and he helped his ball club open up the wide lead that they have right now.
You think KC Jones is going to have a problem with Kevin Porter in this series? He had him on the bench as the first half came to an end.
Certain situations dictate certain things. When the Bullets are on their game, Porter has the advantage when the bigger guys are playing him. When they're not on their game, then that's when he's at a disadvantage, and that's when a guy like Havlicek or Paul Westphal in particular can use him down low and post him and then take advantage of that situation in the ball game.
Sonny, before we got started, you said the key matchup would be Dave Cowens against Elvin Hayes, and of course it was until Cowens got into foul trouble. They had to switch him over on Wes Unseld. That seemed to open things up for Elvin a little bit.
Yes, it did, and the thing that you should watch in the first half was when Cowens went down low on the number 6 play that you pointed out and Oscar pointed out. Notice how he was not able to come across to the lane. And that's the thing that Hayes does so well and forced him away from the basket. Conversely, the thing that happened is that he was put in the situation of being in foul trouble in the ball game.
All right, Sonny. So here, after one half, the Boston Celtics have things well in hand. But Washington figures to come on strong in the second half and change this game around a bit.
Hello, I'm Bob Cousy. You know, I'm very proud to be a member of the National Basketball Hall of Fame. Here in the Honors Court, you see the portraits of the great men in the history of the game, along with the listings of the contributions each made to basketball. So why not plan a visit to Basketball Hall of Fame in Springfield, Massachusetts, on the campus of Springfield College? It's open daily except for Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's Day.
Well, back here, halftime at the Boston Garden. I guess Sonny Hill, everyone can pick out the picture they like best in that quad.
That's a good-looking description of everybody. That shows all the involvement of what happens at a basketball game. And you see K.C. Jones and Bernie Bickerstaff in the upper left-hand side trying to determine what kind of strategy they're going to use in the second half to overcome the Celtic lead in the first half.
All right, Oscar Robertson has spoken to K.C. Jones and Tommy Heinsohn, and let's go to O now for a report.
Well, first for K.C. Jones, Brent, K.C. felt that the Boston defense took him right out of his game. He went in the locker room at the halftime. He said he's going to try to get it back together. And Coach Heinsohn said, we're going to run. And from that description of the game so far, that's the way we have it. And now back over to Brent.
All right, Oscar, thank you. We're just about ready to start the second half. We can take a look at some of the statistics after the first half action as K.C. Jones and Bernie Bickerstaff move over to the Washington bench. Field goal percentage, fairly even. Washington even outshot them. Elvin Hayes with a great first half. Free throws, close, assists, rebounds. Get down there to turnovers, and you'll see why the Celtics have this lead. Washington has turned that ball over 14 times, and Boston only 4. The Celtics have stolen it 5. As we take a look at the team scoring, there's Elvin Hayes up there with 18, Chenier with 10. Wesley Unseld still has not scored, but then he really does not score that much. That is not too unusual. As for Boston's team scoring, it looks this way. JoJo White with 13, 3 other players in double figures, including Havlicek, who played both forward and guard in the first half of this basketball game. Elvin Hayes will move out. He will jump center against Dave Collins. We're just about ready to go.
The coach at halftime, and K.C. Jones said that his team was taken out of their plays by the defense, but he's going to try to make a couple little switches here. Maybe it'll get them started again.
Collins and Hayes shake hands. Richie Powers is throwing it up. The Celtics control it. Havlicek goes to JoJo White. Now JoJo brings it back to set the play. Cheney wheels it to Silas. Unseld is on Silas. Hayes looks for Collins. He's got him. Havlicek rolls one. Reardon was right there. Chenier Silas was battling Wesley Unseld.
Offensive foul. Paul Silas. But, you know, notice it came right out of the halftime situation. You can see this play right here. Paul gets the ball. Little shoulder right in the west.
Two fouls, though, on Paul.
Yeah. But I noticed the Boston, they opened it up a little bit. They got going with that 3-out, 2-under type offense.
There's Elvin Hayes with the ball. Silas is watching it also. Collins is still on Unseld. Hayes turns it around. There was a whistle blown.
Oh, and he got hit in the face that time by Paul Silas.
So Silas has come out here and picked up 2 quick fouls, 3 for the game. Hayes was shooting. Oh, he comes to the line.
Look at that again. We see him right here. He gets the ball over White's head.
Can't add to his point total. This will be his last one. Collins says he wants to switch. He and Silas.
Thank you.
Richie Powers asked one of the photographers to back up just a couple of steps. In and out. Misses both of them.
Yes, he does. That hurts a little bit.
Dave Collins going to Don Chaney. Chaney with his first shot in the second half. Havlicek battling for the ball on the floor. Unseld ties him up.
Don't fall on him, Wes.
That's 260 pounds, Wesley Unseld. One of the stronger men in the NBA.
And he's quick as a cat.
Tipped away to Kevin Porter's got Chenier on the break. Tried to draw the 3-point, goes for the layup.
That was a smart play that time at White. He couldn't get there. started to go behind him and steal the ball, but he couldn't, and he got 2 points out of it.
It's a 10-point Boston lead. Silas with the basketball. Hayes running, Collins, they get the ball to him, knocked away. Out of bounds, and the Celtics will set it up.
People didn't like that, but Dave didn't say anything about it, so.
Here's JoJo White. Kevin Porter runs into Collins. White is three. Back to
the Celtics. Hey, here comes Washington.
Ridden for the left corner. Dave Collins with a rebound. Back to White. You can tell that Washington's got to move the ball quicker this half.
Yes, they are.
Reardon is picked up by Richie Powers, chasing Havlicek. Reardon is arguing with Richie.
Hey, he really took a shot at somebody there.
His second foul. It's a 12-point Boston lead. Silas with the ball.
Here comes play number two.
Allen shoots it. Ball still free. Silas has got it. Reardon has it knocked away by Silas, but Washington has control. Oh, that's it. Goes to Chenier.
I think Washington was lucky to get that ball that time. They messed around, didn't box Silas off. He got a rebound.
Chenier from the left corner.
Here's Paul.
Silas with a rebound. An easy one. No one contesting him.
Here they come.
Joe White. Chenier has it knocked away. Chenier's open again. Oh, his second great layup. The second half, and Tommy Heitzel wants to talk to him.
Yes, he does, but the same thing that Boston did to Washington in the first half. Defense, creating situation, gets their break started, gets them down the court, and maybe to get them back in the ball game.
It has started to change, Joe. Washington is picking up some momentum.
Ford announces a no-nonsense $250 off the sticker price on not just any new car, but America's best-selling newcomer, Ford Granada. In a limited edition you can order now. Specially equipped with new exterior trim, a new bench seat and vinyl door trim. Also $250 off on limited edition Granadas with options like air conditioning and power steering. Comes in three feature colors in two and four door models. Quantities are limited, so see your Ford dealer and order fast. Ford means value. Look close and compare.
You know, we began working long before we opened our Pizza Hut restaurant. Looks like Mr. Emery's got us another load of fresh vegetables. Jack and Rudy mix up fresh dough. The way we make pizza and pasta and sandwiches makes for some extra work, but it's a lot of fun, too. And when that first customer walks in, we're ready. People here really are the best. And I ought to know, I'm Seth Adams, the manager.
Well, another reminder that next Sunday we'll have that mixed doubles tennis special on the CBS Sports Spectacular. We have mentioned Traybert and Billie Jean King. Pancho Gonzalez will be playing with Rosemary Casals. Frank Sedgman teamed up with Margaret Court. That's next Sunday on the CBS Sports Spectacular at 3:30 p.m. Eastern Time. And here in the Boston Garden, it is a 10-point Celtic lead. Manny Sokol counts bodies and says, we've got 10, let's go. JoJo White brings it down, and Porter is there. Chenier is now on Chaney. Chaney got a move by Chaney. No bad. That is his fourth foul. Chaney, foul trouble. Heisen up on his feet.
Yeah.
Couldn't believe the call.
Those are tough calls, you know, a lot of movement.
Here is Reardon going to Chenier. They play catch. Hayes really being guarded by Chaney on a switch. Chenier hits outside. You see Chaney on the big E that time?
Yeah, but that guard with his arm can go and do that. A lot of guards can't afford to shoot up on big guys like Evan Hayes.
Hayes tries to steal it, gets away to Collins. Silas, Reardon knocked it away. Unsell's got it. Unsell waits, Porter comes free. Crowd thought there was a foul. Porter comes in, gives off to Reardon. Reardon comes back to Chenier. Hayes and Collins battling, and it is Reardon underneath.
Hey! You know, I tell you, those offensive boards are having a toll here. It's a 6-point game now.
Chaney back for the Celtics. Here's JoJo White. Boston needs a hoop. They go to Havlicek. He's bumped by onside. That's three fouls against West.
Well, I tell you, it was a little bump that going on, but it was a unintentional, I think.
Allen with Hayes on him. Way out for his hook that time.
Six. Loose ball foul.
Loose ball foul on Reardon. That's his third.
And that means Celtics keep the basketball.
JoJo White. In and out. Hayes pulled it down in front of Cowens. Gives it off to Kevin Porter. Celtics back well on defense. No break opportunity this time. The Bullets break with that long pass to one of their guards. The Celtics break with two or three passes. Different styles on the move. Hayes with the basketball. Comes to Reardon. Reardon over the right to Porter. Hayes is open.
Oh, and
he's fouled
got it.
He was
Silas.
Fouled by Silas. That is Silas's fourth foul. And suddenly, Boston is in foul trouble.
See that play again? I've been noticing so far, whenever Evan Hayes sets up high like that and passes the ball, then starts to move, and he's a little tougher. He gets open a lot more often.
It is now a three-point Boston Celtic lead. Crowd trying to pick its team up. Cheney goes to Havlicek. Reardon is on him. JoJo White was guarded beautifully, and Washington's got it coming back. Porter brings it down. Porter waits now. He's back and slows up. They set up a play. Porter takes it outside.
Hey, he gets it in.
It is a one-point basketball game. Tommy Heinsohn has called timeout. We've gone far enough playing like this.
I think it's smart for him to call a timeout like this. It breaks the other team's momentum. They've been hitting baskets, rebounds, offensive boards, creating situations. He wants to talk this situation over. This is what he's going to do.
When you're training and getting in shape, it's a gray world. But when the sun comes out, when the flags fly, when the band plays, you're glad you're there. Converse All-Star Training Shoes, selected for use by the U.S. team for the 1976 Olympic Games in Montreal. They could make a difference.
Rechargeable batteries. Starts instantly, runs quietly. The cordless electric lawnmower from Lawn Boy. Convenience of electric mowing. No electric cord. Use it almost anywhere. Get a Lawn Boy. Bring cordless electric mowing to your neighborhood. Lawn Boy dealers listed in your Yellow Pages.
All right, a reminder, next Saturday and Sunday, two more NBA Conference Championship games. Washington at Boston, Saturday, 3:30 Eastern Time, or actually 3 o'clock Eastern Time. Don't miss the first quarter with that incorrect time I gave you. Then on Sunday, Golden State at Chicago, 1 p.m. Eastern Time from the Chicago Stadium. And again, out west tonight in Oakland, Golden State and Chicago will play game one. Was there ever a doubt that we wouldn't wind up with a basketball game here this afternoon, though?
No, I don't think it was a doubt as far as being on paper, but a lot of things happen coming from your home to the arena or from the hotels. You don't know the mental being of a ball player, but and they've gotten into it now. We'll see what happens.
White, Celtics lead it by three.
He has scored every time from that situation, just like last year in the playoffs. Hey, that guy was really tough on that spot. They have to take him out of that situation. They can go the other direction.
Kevin Porter yells out the play and brings it up. Silas has Unsell. Bounce back to Chenier, so Cowens is back over on Elvin Hayes. That was the timeout. Heinsohn used it to change defensive alignments. Kevin Porter with a move against JoJo White. Porter up in the air. Not there, and Cowens pulls down a rebound against the Silas to White.
Yes, he does.
Here come the Celtics. Three-point lead now. We've got 6:55 in the JoJo whistle. Joko picked up the foul. White was on his drive.
That was on number 10 that time.
So it's on Kevin Porter, only his second. He fouled out 12 times in the regular season.
Great
high of any player.
I'm sorry, excuse me. That was a great change of pace that time by JoJo, and he got it right up there and gets the one free throw. You got to stop him early. You can't let a player like that get in that close.
And it's a five-point Celtic lead as JoJo White. Kevin Porter comes down, seeing if he can answer White. Reardon has the ball. Havlicek chasing him.
Pick.
Reardon holding on. They're inside of 10 seconds. Reardon with a shot.
Oh, that's a great shot that time at Reardon.
3-point Boston lead.
It's tough when you let the Celtics get in this close to the basket. It's tough against you. Very difficult.
Hayes keeping Collins out away from the basket. Havlicek passes to Silas on the roll. Pass back. Collins wasn't there. Collins retrieves it. Takes a shot from the corner. And Kevin Porter comes back in a hurry on Hondo Havlicek. Good defense. Boston was right there. Would not give up the break. Cheney comes out. Reardon still with the ball. Havlicek's got Reardon. Cheney's got his man, who's Kevin Porter. Reardon goes to Wes Unseld. He's on the scoreboard.
Yeah, it's his first basket, I believe.
It is a 3-point Celtic lead again. Porter keeps White outside. White goes to Cheney. Shaneer is there. Now they go to Havlicek. Unseld down with the defensive board. No break opportunity. Well covered. So Kevin Porter brings it up.
Reardon really got down good that time. This is what they had to have to get that fast break going, because they need their break.
They get to Shaneer. Not there. Collins.
You know, Brent, he's hesitating just slightly and is throwing him off. He's got to go ahead and shoot the ball.
Havlicek back to the trailer. Collins. He has scored so many times in this situation. Not there. Hayes yanks it down. Now Washington can pull to within 1 point. 5:14 to go in the third quarter. Kevin Porter brings it up. Goes over to the right side. Reardon with the basketball. They come to the Hayes side. Hayes gets inside Collins. In and out, and Collins at the board. So now it's JoJo White. Here we go.
Look at Dallas get down the court then.
Havlicek loses control. Hayes races him. All free. Collins has it.
Oh.
Back to White. White with a shot. 5-point Boston lead.
Boy, you make a mistake against that team and they'll kill you with it.
Again, it is Kevin Porter down the right side. This time, he goes into the corner. Inside of White. He was traveling, turned it over. Don Nelson checks in for the Celtics.
You know, I tell you, I hate to disagree with the referee here. No, I don't hate to disagree. I think that was a good move.
I was going to say, you haven't turned over a new leaf in the
playoffs. No, yeah, that was a good
you
move by Kevin Porter.
Disagreeing, are you?
Here's I think they're calling a fine ball game so far, but that was a good move by Kevin to get that basket.
Havlicek. Suddenly the Celtics go back up by 7, and down comes Porter. Now it is Washington in need of a hoop. 4:10 to go in the third. Shaneer with the ball. Collins has Hayes way out away from the basket. Shaneer swings around to the left side. Shaneer. Unseld battling. Havlicek has it. Cheney's got the break. And on the other side is White. Hayes ball. White with a shot. Not there. Shaneer battles. There's a foul underneath.
Oh, that's Cheney's fifth foul.
Don Cheney is in foul trouble. Silas is on the bench. We'll see Westfall. He'll be checking in. And that means they'll send Jones and Witherspoon. So KC Jones counters with a couple of substitutions in this situation.
Yes, he does.
Mike Reardon goes over for Les Shaneer leaves. It'll be Jones and Porter in that Washington backcourt. Celtics with a 7-point lead as these lineup changes are made. White picks up Porter on the Elvin Hayes side. Jimmy Jones is picked up by Westfall. They go to Hayes. Hayes waits for Witherspoon. Now he's going to turn around inside.
And he gets it there.
That's 23 points for the Big E. Back comes JoJo White. Lead pass behind on Havlicek. Tried to go to Collins. Out there with a Spoon with a rebound. Spoon hesitated. He probably should have gone to Kevin Porter with that outlet pass.
I think he should have. If they had done that, they'd have gotten out of court a lot faster than there. And the defense of Celtics would not be set the way it is right now. The way this school too long to get that ball down the court.
All right, Jimmy Jones in the right corner. Tries to get Spoon open. He comes out the other side, takes a pass from outside.
Well, they were patient that time. They got it home.
It is a 3-point Boston Celtic lead. White and Havlicek and Westfall. Nelson and Collins. This is Collins. Not there. Westfall with an offensive board and a shot. Great body control.
Yes, he gets it home.
It's a 5-point Celtic lead. Kevin Porter tries to get inside on White. Knocked away. Collins has it. Outlet pass to Westfall. Jones gets back. Unseld is there. They hit Nelson. Pioneer go the boys. Down they come. Elvin Hayes. Quick pass to Kevin Porter.
And the redhead wants it. You talk a lot about ball players, guards that they set up basketball games, plays, and whatnot, runs the offense. You know, JoJo White should get a lot of credit doing that because he does a very good job.
Leonard Robinson is going to check in. Porter gets inside with a tremendous move. Not there. Hayes with an offensive board. Still not there.
Hayes retrieves it again. Good job by the E. Comes back.
Oh, the big E. Back over the head, Dunk.
Oh, things are warming up in the Boston Garden. Nelson's back to the three-point game. Don Nelson back to Hondo. In and out, and Hayes working at both ends.
You think Hayes is getting, Nelson will get a little tired?
Oh, what a war this is going to be here in the closing minutes. Kevin Porter, game one of the Eastern Conference Final. Porter waits now. Spoon rotates around the other side.
Jones, yeah, they don't have too much time to shoot.
They've got to hurry. They're inside of 4 seconds. Spoon will take it.
No, drop.
Oh, Havlicek, just beautiful. Foul, Spoon, and then Westphal. And Spoon's got the loose ball.
Hold it.
There's a foul.
Hold it. He's it on. 17.
Tremendous action, but he called a foul on Havlicek. I don't think Tommy Heinsohn can believe it.
Good block.
Havlicek. Right there.
Yeah.
Right there. He caught him.
Oh, watch the big E give Cowan to slip back over. Good dunk.
Well, that's what it was, and that's 4 fouls on Havlicek.
Announcing not just a sale, but a way to get a special price on America's bestsellers. A bestseller sale at your Ford dealer. Get a special price on a specially equipped Mustang II, America's best-selling small luxury car. On Maverick, traditionally America's best-selling four-door compact. Or choose Pinto, America's top-selling small economy car. Your Ford dealer has been given a special incentive to give you a good buy on America's best-selling lowest price lineup. Ford means value. See your local Ford dealer. Look close and compare.
Keep, you can buy a powder to help keep your feet dry, and you can buy a cooling foot refresher, and you can buy an athlete's foot treatment. Or you can buy Desinex. Desinex does it all. Sprayed into shoes and boots, it helps keep feet dry and comfortable. Sprayed through stockings, it soothes and cools hot, tired, aching feet. And medicated Desinex powder helps relieve itchy, burning, peeling feet. Athlete's foot. Desinex. It does a lot more than just fight athlete's foot.
For your vacation, Hertz has more of what you need. More economy-sized cars. Ford Pintos at $9.99 a day, plus mileage and gas. Four-door Mavericks at $13.99, plus mileage and gas. Rent for a week and get unlimited mileage. To get these non-discountable rates, you call Hertz or your travel agent for a confirmed reservation. Rates apply at most, but not all locations, and exclude Manhattan. Hertz has more of these cars than anyone. Number one has more of what you need.
Three for Terry Bradshaw.
And you watch the big redhead with a great left-handed outlet pass. Over the head, kiss. Tremendous block right there. Good action going on.
Now watch John Havlicek, number 17, the action under the boards. And you'll see him come up with his right hand right there on Witherspoon. That was the foul on Hondo. And he has 4. Cheney has 5. Silas has 4.
And Len Robinson is in the game for Wesley Unsel right now. I thought Wes didn't get back down the court then, so they're going to give him a little rest.
And Leonard Robinson with his first shot.
Well, hey, how about that? That's the way you come into a game, as I said earlier.
White was calling a play, and Westphal gave him the ball back. White still controls it. Boston's lead is down to 1.
They got Porter guarding Nelson now.
Nelson wants it. They can't get it into it. Shot clock inside at 10. There's the pass. Porter battling. Havlicek. And there's a foul. It's on Elvin Hayes. That's his 4th. It's over telling Manny Sokol what he thought about that call.
It looked like he hit him that time. We'll look at it again. Where did he hit it?
Sokol was right behind him when he made that call, you know, so he saw Hayes' body. And I don't know how much contact there was out in front.
Maybe he should have been in front of it.
Well, I'll tell you, Oscar, I've said this to you privately. I think this game is almost impossible to officiate perfectly because of the movement and the size of these athletes.
This is true. You're right.
Hayes goes off to the sideline, but so they're going to bring Kozelko in.
But Elvin Hayes has 4 fouls. He's upset about that. He says he didn't touch anybody. He can get a good overhead view, see if he can get a good play set up here by Washington.
It's a 3-point Boston lead. Kozelko has replaced Hayes, goes to Jones, works on Westphal.
You know, that's his game right there. He's got to get down there 15 feet into the basket. I don't think he's that good a shot out further. Maybe he can shoot out further, but I haven't seen him shoot that far from the basket yet.
1 point game. Jones watching Westfall. Robinson has Nelson. Kozelko is fronting Collins. He's just staying in front of him. There's Havlicek.
He made a mistake that time. The defense wasn't patient enough to stay with Havlicek, and he gets the basket.
It's a 3-point Celtic lead.
Five.
Goes to Kozelko. Only 2 seconds left in the quarter. Robinson's got to hurry. He didn't get it off.
No, not in time.
So there'll be no basket, and we have come to the end of three quarters in the Boston Garden with 12 minutes of regulation time ahead of us, and the Boston Celtics leading the Washington Bullets by 3 points.
You'll see the best in basketball when you watch the NBA. When you watch the NBA on CBS.
You know what's up here? High prices. Almost anything you can name today is right up there. But there are still some great bargains way down here. Values you may never see again. And where do you get these values? Right here in the market. There may never be a better time to see your broker. Sure, nothing's guaranteed. But he can tell you about the great buys you can get in stocks and bonds. The market. Today, there's no better place to pick up a bargain.
Hey, Detroit, how about a special offer for guys who need big cars?
Ford presents a new limited edition Ford that's sticker priced at least $332 less than full-size Fords have been. It comes with automatic transmission, power steering, power brakes, steel-belted radials, and more. There's also a lower-priced limited edition of America's favorite full-size wagon. But quantities are limited, so order now for best selection. Ford means value. See your local Ford dealer. Look close and compare.
Press the button of Polaroid's SX70 land camera.
Say cheese.
Cheddar.
Dave Cowens has pulled down 16 rebounds in this playoff game. Wes Unseld has pulled down 8 and has been held to 1 field goal. And Elvin Hayes has checked back in with those 4 fouls. He'll jump center. Backs is off of Collins, and finally it's Spoon who's got it. Like a pinball machine out there. Jones with the ball, gives to Kevin Porter.
Yeah, this is the final 4 minutes of the game. They got to start. Teams have got to start moving right now.
Here's Jones. Knocked away by Westfall. Collins goes to JoJo White. White has scored 21 points. Silas is in the game. He's working with Nelson. Now White, offense, says Richie. That's his third. So he pushed off getting inside. A 3-point game. The Bullets come down on the attack. Phil Chenier is on the bench. He scored 16 so far. Witherspoon holds the ball. Westfall has Hayes in the situation. Silas drops back in the double team. Witherspoon waits for the pass back. Now Hayes turn around.
Yes, he gets it there. But I tell you, he was right. Elvin Hayes was right that time. Witherspoon should have cleared through the middle, taking his man out of the way to leave a one-on-one situation for Elvin. But he did. He got the basket anyway.
A 1-point basketball game. Collins gets inside of Elvin. Taken down by Unseld off the Spoon. Goes to Kevin Porter. Havlicek waits to check in. Porter.
Oh, dropped in. That's a real, oh, the real gutty move that time. That was a gutty move by the little guy. He went right in on Collins. Silas and Nelson got it in.
Well, the Bullets have suddenly pulled ahead in this game. Westfall guarded by Jones. Left-handed threw it up. Taken down by Unseld.
Duke West is upset that he...
Chenier and Havlicek will check in. Here's Elvin Hayes.
That's on Westfall.
It's his first.
Watch the Big E right here again. He gets hit right there and he goes up and shoots, which is what you have to do in that situation. When you get hit, those shooters love to get those chances at the foul line. Go for that 3-point play.
Henry Finkel is going to check in, and Dave Collins is going to get a rest. Havlicek is in. Silas, White, and Nelson. Havlicek will play guard. Chenier is back in. Hayes, Unsell, Porter, and Weatherspoon. 10:31 for the game. And a three-point Washington lead. They trail at the half by 12 points. JoJo White is back. Here's Hank Finkel. And there's a whistle. It's an offensive call.
Yes, it
is. On Nelson.
Now the Cowboys is out of the game. Seems to me they're going to go into Nelson for some one-on-one stuff down low. They can keep the game even until Dave gets a rest and they can get him back into the game.
Washington can go ahead by five if they can hit here. Elvin Hayes at the left baseline.
And they go ahead by five. That big guy's really been playing some game.
Now it is Havlicek, and you will see the Celtics under pressure. They thrive on it. Havlicek goes to Paul Silas. Silas waits, turns to the left. Havlicek is open. In and out. Hayes with a rebound. It's three on two. Chenier, but they go to Weatherspoon. Chenier at the board.
Chenier tipped it in. Good board work. Hey, they got to talk this over. The Celtics do. Wow, what a turnaround in this game, Brent.
It is a seven-point lead for the Washington Bullets as you watch this in slow motion. Chenier going up. And that gives him 18 points for the game, 9:44 to play.
He flies to faraway places, bringing last week's letters, yesterday's newspapers, and memories of home. Now comes Miller time. Time to head for the best-tasting beer you can find. America's quality beer, Miller High Life.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer. The time we've got the beer.
Miller beer.
Madison Square Garden, it isn't just a driveway and a hoop, but that's where you need a basketball that can take a beating. A Voight ball. Special materials and construction give it durability. One good reason why more Voight basketballs are sold worldwide than any other brand. That's why AMF puts its name on the line too. And that name adds even more value to sports products like Voight basketballs. AMF brings out the best in you.
I'd like to repeat that story about referee Mindy Rudolph, who remains hospitalized in Washington because of a blood clot which ran from his leg to a lung during a basketball game on Friday night. Mindy did not suffer a heart attack. Please do not call the hospital in Washington. He is not accepting any phone calls. He is listed in fair condition.
You know, we have 9:44 to go in this game now, Brent. You're going to see some real hard-hitting basketball because the Celtics have got to get back into the game, and right away.
They trail up by 7 points. Porter is out on JoJo White. Here is Paul Silas. Celtics need a basket to pick things up for them. There's Nelson.
Yeah. They mix it up a little bit, a little movement up the high post play, and they got a basket.
Now, let's see if Washington can answer that immediately. They lead it by five. Silas has Weatherspoon. Collins is over there on Hayes. They come to Kevin Porter. White watches him. Porter goes to the Hayes side. Here's Elvin.
Yeah, he's beautiful today. E.
To a seven-point lead. Havlicek to JoJo White. Porter awaits White. Chenier will take Havlicek. Who's at guard? They try to work the same play. Porter deflects it. Havlicek goes to Collins. Silas at the boards. Not there. Tip back. Here's JoJo.
Yes.
23 points for JoJo White.
That play was made possible by Silas keeping that ball alive on the offensive board. He couldn't control it, so he batted it back outside to JoJo White, who got the basket.
Celtic fans chanting for some defense. Nelson watches Unsell. Throws it out of bounds. Chenier was breaking baseline. He stopped, but the pass was on its way.
Yeah, he tried to go back door on Havlicek, but it didn't work.
Now the Celtics have cut it down to within three. They trail by five. JoJo. It's a three-point basketball game. 8:22 to play, and here comes Kevin Porter. Chenier. Back to Porter. In and out, and Silas to White. Now they can pull back to within 1 point. JoJo White comes over to the right-hand side. In behind Silas, Havlicek is there. Come back outside, and goes back to Havlicek. Out there, Collins, offense. Casey Jones wants a timeout.
great play. Great play by the Redhead. He just simply out-jumped Uncle to get the ball and knocked it right in.
Playoff basketball in the Boston Garden. What an offensive rebound. He didn't even come down. Oh, he just threw it right in the hoop.
Ford announces a no-nonsense $250 off the sticker price on not just any new car, but America's best-selling newcomer, Ford Granada. In a limited edition you can order now. Specially equipped with new exterior trim, a new bench seat and vinyl door trim. Also $250 off on limited edition Granadas with options like air conditioning and power steering. Comes in three feature colors in two- and four-door models. Quantities are limited, so see your Ford dealer and order fast. Ford means value. Look close and compare.
People don't usually make a habit of discussing antiperspirant sprays in public. But there's one called Sure that's so different, I don't mind talking about it. Look, most antiperspirant sprays go on wet and oily, compared to Sure, which goes on dry. Obviously, this doesn't prove that Sure will keep you drier, but that's something you can prove to yourself, under your own two arms. Isn't that where it really counts? Try Sure on your left side, and the antiperspirant spray you like best on your right side. And if you're like most people, your left side will be drier than your right side, I'm sure. But you don't have to listen to me. You've got two arms, you decide. Try Sure on your left side. It'll convince your right side, I'm sure.
A capacity crowd at the Boston Garden urging their Celtics to play some defense. They trail by a point, 7:48. Witherspoon goes to Chenier out high. Hayes comes away with Collins. They go to Chenier. He goes right side shot.
Oh! They set that up good for Chenier all the way to shoot. Uncle set a great pick for him. Got it in.
3-point Washington lead. JoJo White goes to Silas. Silas holds it outside the free throw line. Don Nelson with Witherspoon all over him. They're going to Havlicek. Chenier gives him a little bit of room, but not too much. Havlicek comes into the right side. Congestion, they wheel it back as a whistle.
That's on Witherspoon this time.
That's his third. Team fouls, one apiece so far. Havlicek back out to Silas. Chenier watching Hondo. Here's Nelson. Good defense by Washington. Here's Collins with a shot. Pulled down by Wes Unseld. Now they can build that lead to 5 points with a hoop here.
It seems right now Washington's going to be patient, come down and set up the ball instead of trying to run with the Celtics.
Nelson all over Unseld. They go to Porter with it. Goes into Hayes. Hold on. There's a foul. That is Havlicek, who was holding against Hayes. That's five against Hondo.
Yeah, we got the holding right. Let's see. Right there, I believe. Got his hands on him.
Havlicek with a steal on a pass from Hayes. Collins is on his right-hand side. They go to Collins. A one-point game against 6:38.
That's that pressure defense again, even though the Big E should not have forced that ball there. Turned it over, and Celtics got a basket.
Porter goes to Elvin Hayes. Collins all over, and they come to Witherspoon. Silas gives him some room out there. Silas waits at Chenier.
I don't know. He may not have been hitting early, but he sure knocked his last two in very well.
Celtics come down, trailing by three. Nelson goes to Havlicek, 6-12 for the ball game. Chenier has Hondo. Hondo wants to come over the right side. Porter's running White. White wants an alley-oop over him. Doesn't get it. They come to Silas. Unconscious. Take it away. Hayes. No daylight on that pass. Not a good pass that situation. Here comes Kevin Porter. Porter sets up the play. They can build that lead to five again. There's a whistle. That's on Hayes. That's his fifth foul.
That's his fifth foul. Yeah, he pushed off then.
So five fouls on Elvin Hayes. Havlicek with the basketball. They go to JoJo White. 5:38 for the game. Nelson not there. Unseld with the rebound.
Here they come.
Kevin Porter.
Porter to Witherspoon inside.
And he gets it there. That's a good break that time. But they're patient. They want to come down and get a good play. They don't want to rush that ball down the court and make a lot of costly turnovers, I'm sure.
Trailing by five, trying to set a play up. Here's Hondo Havlicek.
Oh, 19. Offensive foul on Nelson.
That's his second. Five, 15 on the game clock. 5-point Washington lead. Game one of the Eastern Conference Finals. Elvin Hayes goes to Nick Witherspoon. Witherspoon against Paul Silas. Comes down to the left side. Turn around.
Wow, he knocked it in. That was play number two, folks.
It is a 7-point bullet lead. White outside. Now it's five. Celtic backcourt pressure. Witherspoon goes to himself back quickly to Porter. 4:44 in the game clock. Here's Kevin Porter. Porter goes in and comes back out. Cheney is going to check back in. He has five fouls. Hayes is playing with five fouls. They come over here to Witherspoon. Silas watching him. Drop it off to Hayes. The Collins trying to keep him outside. Turn around. Whistle underneath.
On Collins?
That's his third foul.
Did see that?
And his first since early in this basketball game. Hayes hits the first one. 6-point bullet lead. Collins with the rebound. JoJo White pumps it down for him. Comes over to the left side of the free throw line. Bounce to Cheney. Knocked away by Witherspoon out of bounds. It'll stay with the Celtics.
Good steal that time. I think that play surprised Witherspoon because he may not thought he was going to get to it, but he did. He could have maybe taken it on down the court.
Silas sets a pick, but JoJo goes the other way. Try to trap on defense, come outside to Havlicek. Witherspoon has him. They go to Silas, quickly to Cheney. So Cheney comes off the bench and becomes the open man immediately.
But they're real patient doing that. They move that ball around much better than any team in the league.
A 4-point Washington lead. 3:54 on that game clock. Kevin Porter against JoJo White. Porter comes over here to Wes Unseld, who shoots outside. In and out. JoJo White with a Celtic rebound. That's right down the middle. Forced to slow it up. Good defense by the Bullets. They come. Cheney's open again. Not this time, Unseld at the defensive board. Outlet pass to Kevin Porter. Porter waits, takes his time.
Yes, he does.
Unseld slowly comes down to join the attack. Anybody's tired in that Washington team, it's got to be Big West. West quickly, Elvin Hayes, knocked away by Collins, regained by Elvin. Now it is Hayes on the manure, turn around. Moved it off balance,
yeah.
The foul, Witherspoon,
was right.
In on Havlicek. And that is his fourth foul.
That was a good call.
Coach Tommy Heitzen looking on as his Celtics trail it by four. 3:13, they can cut that right in half with a hoop here. JoJo White comes to the right corner, and there's a foul. Kevin Porter fouling as he tried to get out into the right corner. Let's take a look at the team situation. 3 against the Celtics, 3 against Washington.
Coach Jones didn't like that call, I don't believe, Brent.
They can pull it in two. It is Collins, but hold on. Offense says Sokol.
And
can't believe it.
Woo! Watch this play again. There was some definite contact, but I don't think it was that hard that he had to fall out like that. But he got a foul out of it.
Elvin Hayes got the job done when he backed off.
Yes, he did.
Heitzen still yelling at Manny Sokol about that call.
Big guy's really upset, isn't he? You know, you talk about a lot of one-on-one basketball players. You know, as a forward, he was very tough to guard one-on-one. He had some real good moves. He didn't shoot a real long shot outside as far as 20, 25 feet goes. But he got in there and did a great job.
Oscar, when Red Auerbach hired Bill Russell, he talked to Tommy Heitzen about taking the job originally. Heitzen said, there's only one man for you to hire,
That's Bill Russell. He's the only man who can handle Bill Russell. So it was Tommy Heinsohn who made the suggestion. I'm sure that Auerbach probably got it from other people. And now that Bill Russell has moved on and become a very successful coach, I might add, out at Seattle, Tommy Heinsohn comes in here, and I think he's done a good job with his franchise. You know, it's got to be tough to be the coach when you got Red Auerbach as your general manager. Not that he's difficult to work for, but you got the legend up above you.
That's,
you know,
true,
what can you do to improve on that record?
Well, he's done. Tommy's done an excellent job here. He's got some good ball players to mix in and play as a unit. Got Paul Salas in a trade. That was a great deal.
Well, Tommy Heinsohn puts on some show for you.
Right,
now we take a musical look at him.
I got a right to cry. All day I sang the blues. I'm in my lonely shoes.
All right, it's about time we got a little down-home music on this broadcast. Oscar, you've been getting that soul in all these games.
Well, that was down-home. You're right about that. Yeah.
We want more Conway Twitter. Bring on those folks.
We do?
91-87. Rails, ready for the game. A.C. Jones. Always one expression, one of calmness. Kevin Porter goes to Elvin Hayes. Trying to build their lead to six. Shot clock moves down toward 10 seconds. Game clock at 2:50. Here's Kevin Porter. Silas has him. Elvin Hayes outside. In and out. Silas out to JoJo White. They can pull it within 2 points. Chaney was on his left. White's going to come around. Hold up with Porter on him. Chaney has it knocked out of bounds by Chenier.
Yeah, that was a good play by Chenier because Chaney was wide open for a jump shot.
15 seconds on the shot clock. Down it goes. 2:35 for the game. Collins to the basketball. Trailing by four. Collins against Hayes. In, not there, Chenier.
Here we go. The break.
Porter's got Spoon on his left. There it is. Havlicek.
Oh, that was good by Spoon that time. He got hit. He went on up with the ball anyway.
That's it for Hondo.
Hey, Havlicek. That's John's sixth foul.
He has fouled out of this basketball game.
Here comes Kevin, gets the ball into Spoon. He's fouled. He goes on up to the basket anyway. It's very important for them to make these free throws, to make at least one of them.
It'll be Witherspoon, who will be coming to the line. Beth Havlicek looking on. Bill Ford, the Washington trainer, is over with Nick Witherspoon. He fell against that basket support after he was fouled. Oscar, I tell you, Havlicek almost has to do it in that situation, doesn't he?
I think so. You know, it was a crucial situation. It would have put him up 6 points. But he's fouled out of the ball game, Brent. I think that's the only bad part about it.
It's Don Nelson who's checked back in. White is over talking to Tommy Heinsohn. So here's a second-year pro, Nick Witherspoon, at that line. A 5-point Washington lead.
Stay there.
If he misses this one, Havlicek will feel a little better.
But he did miss it.
6-point Washington lead. Collins out away from the basket, goes to Don Nelson, who has replaced Havlicek. Nelson goes to Collins, who's usually deadly there. He's off right now. Chenier with a rebound.
Yeah, they're going to use a lot of time up now. They know what he's got, 6 points on the clock. 2:04 on the clock, I should say, up by 6 points. They're going to work it into the Big E.
Chenier going to Wes Unseld. Go to the other side to Kevin Porter. Shot clock down now to 5 seconds. Here's Chenier.
Oh, I tell you, he has really hit some big hoops with them, and he steals this one. They should be patient again. They shouldn't worry about shooting this ball. He does that. Great basketball. Good hand in that play.
A tremendous comeback by the Washington Bullets. They lead it by 8 points with 1:35 to go. If they lose it, they'll have to give it away. Chenier has it knocked away. Spoon picks up the loose ball. Saved by White to Collins. Shot clock went off anyway, so it's going to belong to the Celtics. The 24-second violation. Now give it to JoJo White. Look at that Washington sideline.
They're going to take that home court advantage right away from them. Chaney comes down. Chenier's with him. Second game Wednesday night down in Landover, Maryland. Nelson down at the right baseline. They've got to put it up in a hurry. Not there. Battle Chaney on the board.
Gets it in.
109. 6-point Washington lead.
There'll be some pressure there. There'll be a pressure here by the Celtics. So they call a timeout to get the ball in half court. Good play.
Position timeout called by Washington. Chenier has something to say to Richie Powers. K.C. Jones was pointing to some debris that was on the floor.
I think Chenier got in the way of some elbows down there a while ago. That's what he's talking about. It can be rough out there sometimes.
Well, it's 95-89 with 109. It's not impossible. But the Washington Bullets present a very formidable opponent right now. Don't forget, next week, more of the same, Saturday and Sunday. At Saturday, you'll see another game between Washington and Boston. That will be the third one of this series, and that'll start at 3 p.m. Eastern time. Then on Sunday, it'll be Golden State at Chicago, 1 p.m. Eastern time. Both playoff games coming up on CBS. Well, Oscar, in a few moments, you can break and go on down to the locker room. Once Washington starts to make some mistakes, you'll be talking to Elvin Hayes and some of his friends over there in the Bullets.
Yeah, I hope to get Chenier as well, because I think that even though he didn't shoot that well before at time, he has come through and hit some real big hoops for them. He's been having a little trouble in the last playoff games against Buffalo, but he's come out very well in this game.
Washington players huddled around K.C. Jones. Trailed by 12 points at the half. John Havlicek, who just fouled out a few moments ago, playing in his 144th playoff game. Only four players in the NBA have been in more. Chamberlain, Russell, Sam Jones, and Jerry West. So they will try to protect the 6-point lead. They have put Reardon in the game. Good ball handler. He'll go in at forward, but it's like a third guard, and Reardon calls timeout.
Oh, he was right on time with that one. Was he lucky to get that timeout then?
That's all your timeout.
And that is all of the Washington Bullets timeouts. So they got to go the rest of the way.
That was a real heady play. You talk a lot about ball players making plays on the court. Even though the ball was not in play at that time, Reardon made a real good call by calling another timeout.
What's Heinsohn mad about now?
I don't know. He seems to be upset with Manny about something, Grant. I don't know exactly what it is myself. I'd like to find out, too.
Probably the situation in this ball game.
Could be, because this is a tough game.
You bet it is. They had the home court advantage. They played well in the first half, and they may blow this one.
Well, it's not over yet. They got a minute nine. They're down six. You know, nothing's really impossible.
Could hurt that team not to have a timeout left. You give up a couple of hoops and get them under pressure, you could really spin here.
That's true, especially if Boston can get the ball and score. It will take away the timeout underneath the basket, so therefore Washington will not be able to get the ball at half court.
Now watch this Celtic defense. Washington is up in the attack court. They wanted that position when they called the first of two timeouts. Silas will go over to harass Reardon. They go to Unseld. And he's Nelson.
It's on Nelson.
Nelson's third foul.
Hey, that's a bonus.
Unseld has scored only 2 points in this game. One field goal.
When he gets that one, that's a big basket. Big free throw, I should say.
And Joe White back in a hurry. Nelson. Now the pressure will come on. It is a 5-point Washington lead. It is Nelson again on the backcourt against Unseld.
Yeah, that's on Nelson again. He grabbed him in the backcourt. They're in a desperate situation now, so they have to foul somebody to try to get the ball back again.
So they bring Unseld to the line because they fouled him in the backcourt while he had possession. 59 seconds for the game. A six-point bullet lead. Where did that one go? Wesley lost total control, I think.
Yeah, but he's feeling good about this game. He knows they got it in the bag right now, unless a miracle can occur.
Here's the penalty.
Yes, he gets it there.
Seven-point lead. Chaney back. 57 seconds. Half shoot in a hurry. Nelson battle underneath, taken away by Unsell. Unsell comes up with the outlet. Collins knocks it away. It'll be Chaney quickly to Don Nelson. Nelson inside the line.
Good hoop.
Now it is a five-point lead. Pressure on. Chaney comes back. We've got 40 seconds to go. They trap him. Three men right there. That's Bob Stoller. Here comes JoJo White. White down over the left side. Puts one up. Oh, ridden down. Just about the end. He's fouled. That's Chaney's sixth foul. He'll lead. Back court. Ridden have come to the line. So go ahead, O, and break on down to that locker room. So in the first game of the Eastern Conference Finals, the Boston Celtics have blown a 12-point halftime lead. And it's important because they surrender that home court advantage. Ridden misses the first. Remember, he had two because it was in the backcourt, and also there's a penalty situation. He scored six on a game, and now it's seven, and here comes the penalty. 7-point Washington bullet lead. Down to the last 25 seconds. Westfall can't hit it. Reardon pulls down that rebound again. Collins takes it away. Not enough time. Hayes says move back. 5 points. Kevin Porter down to 15 seconds. That's what they have to kill. Porter goes to Unsell. Quickly to Reardon. Have to do is pass it around now and just kill that clock. 5-point lead, and the Washington Bullets have won the first game, and they did it on the Boston Celtics home court. Kevin Porter tosses one up at the buzzer. Final score, 195. K.C. Jones leading the Washington Bullets off toward their locker room. Right behind the Boston Celtic players, we'll be going inside that Washington locker room to talk to some of the stars. Oscar Robertson will be in there. You can see how happy that outfit is. Came off that tough seven-game series against Buffalo, and they win the first one against the Boston Celtics.
Here in the Caribbean, Jaime Moscoso, a master of the soil, breeds tobacco for Dutch Master Cigars. Today he must select the best plants so that flowers can be bagged to protect the purity of their seed. Bagging is a master's way to be sure the great taste of Dutch Masters doesn't change. Now you see why a Dutch Masters like our Panatella is worth more. There really are masters at Dutch Masters.
Who do I see about a loan?
Who do I see about a check that bounced?
Who do I see about credit checking?
Who do I see about my savings account?
Who do I see about getting
saved? Do you ever get the feeling that banks are a string of faceless people who never heard of you? Well, not at Irving Trust. We have personal bankers. We've assigned personal bankers to all of our customers. Just one person for you to call or see, whether it's about checking accounts, loans, savings, whatever. Isn't that what you've been looking for? Get personal with Irving.
Back at the Boston Garden, where the Boston Celtics have just lost to the Washington Bullets, 100-95. Sonny Hill has joined us here at our broadcast table. Sonny, before the game, you said that Westfall and Weatherspoon were going to be big factors coming off the bench. How did that turn out in game one?
Westfall scored 4 points, and Weatherspoon came on very strong in the second half. He scored 13 points, and I feel strongly that the play of those two players throughout this series will determine who will ultimately be the victor in this best of seven series between these two clubs.
Sonny, I thought that Washington did it in very convincing fashion in the second half.
I thought they came back and played their game, and the Celtics really didn't pressure him too much in those last few minutes. I mean, the score was close, but here we are in the Boston Celtics home court, and I thought it was the Bullets who did the job.
They turned it around, though. They sort of played defense the way the Celtics did in the first half, and that's what happened in the second half for Washington.
Assistant coach Bernie Bickerstaff was in the locker room talking to some of the Washington players. Oscar Robertson, of course, is in there. He's going to be talking to Elvin Hayes and also Phil Chenier when we go inside and pick him up. So he's getting set, and let's go to Oscar now.
I'm with you now with the Big 8. Guy played, I think, a super game today. Hey, you know, you watch the Celtics play in the first half, and I watched you guys play as well. You seem to be cautious out there for a while.
Well, you know, last time we played them up here, that Friday night before the season end, they did so many new things. I think that we just tried to stand back and see what they was coming at us new with. But once we saw that we had got down by 12 or 13 points, we had to come back in the ball game. So I just thank God that we was able to get offense going and get the defense generated and get them back into the ball game. In that third period, that was a big period for us. That was a period that most times we usually didn't come out that hot, but tonight we really came out there, very aggressive ball, and we was fortunate to win the ball game. But I tell you, it's just a tremendous game.
You know, after a long, grueling seven-game series with Buffalo, you know, this had to take a lot of mental pressure off of you, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. You know, that was a tremendous mental series, you know, trying to contain McAdoo and the guys. But I think that playing seven game with such a fantastic ball club, it kind of helped us more so than I think hurt us, because it let us get a lot of work on a lot of things, a lot of our mistakes out of the way, a lot of things that we was rust in, we was able to work on them against a great team like the Buffalo Braves. But I tell you, it really paid off that series with Buffalo today, coming out here today, getting a big win.
You know, a lot of people never worry about your overall play, how you get back on defense. You sacrifice a lot of times with individual defense to help your team. I think you do a great job overall, because you do a lot of things that's not noticed in the box score.
Oh, that's true. A lot of people, you know, they look and see how many points you scored, how many rebounds, but it's more to the game. It's, you know, passing off to the open guy, getting back, cutting off the guys from cutting down the middle, getting over when a guy think he's got away, block the shot, and creating things for your teammates. Because when you have a certain ability in one area of the game where people respect you so much, it tend to draw people, and this open up things for your teammates. And this is when you start to use your ability to get your teammates open, get them a shot, or help them out on defense, create things that normally wouldn't be created out there if you were just maybe going for yourself in that one area where people think you're going for.
Yeah, that's true. What was that special timeout you called in the first quarter?
Well, I don't remember that one.
Well, anyway, thanks a lot. I want to get Phil Chenier in, who I think did a great job for you guys down the stretch. So we can get him in right now. But, hey, great ball game, baby.
Thank you very much, y'all.
Now, if we can get Phil in over here for a moment, well, he's tied up right now. But let me go back to Britt now for short pause.
All right, Oscar Robertson. Elvin Hayes wound up with 34 points. It was Phil Chenier with 24, Witherspoon with 13, Kevin Porter with 10, and Reardon with 8.
Well, we were looking for something that would get us good gas mileage. That's probably the primary reason we picked Dotson. And the Dotson has turned out to be sort of a combination workhorse, taxi cab, and just about everything that we've needed in the way of family use. We depend on our Dotson. You bet we do.
And this year, Kurt, Dotson's dependable little hustler also comes in a foot longer version. Now America's number one selling small pickup saves two ways.
A tiny speck of carbon black. If it were in your eye, you wouldn't know it. But carbon black's unique properties strengthen rubber and add miles of wear to your car's tires. And who discovered an economical way to make carbon black for today's tires? The same company that makes fine products for your car. The Phillips Petroleum Company. Surprised?
Now, Phil Chenier. Phil, some big hoops for you out there in the latter stages of the game.
Well, right, Oscar. We're fortunate to run our offense pretty well in the second half, and we were getting the ball to people that were open, and then E hit a couple good hoops for us. And I think when Elvin starts hitting, I think a lot of teams start really trying to concentrate on him, and then it kind of makes it a little more possible for the rest of us to work off of him and try and get open.
Yes, but individually, you haven't been shooting well. You didn't shoot well starting out. You hit a couple baskets in a row, then you missed a few. Mm-hmm. Then down the stretch, your players stayed with you. They had confidence in you, and you knocked them in. You didn't disappoint them.
Well, I hope I don't disappoint them at all anymore.
You know, but a game like this, when you're down 10 points, you have to get a timeout. You go into the locker room at the halftime. What did you talk about?
Well, I think the biggest thing was we threw the ball away a couple times, and a couple times we had fast breaks and we didn't convert them. In fact, we even turned the ball over a couple times, and those are the things that Casey's been pointing out that really hurt you, you know, throughout the outcome of a game. And so he pointed these things out to us and told us to try and get, you know, be a little more deliberate in our offense and, you know, not just take the first shot you see, but, you know, work for a better shot. And I think we had a little bit more patience the second half.
Yeah, but your defensive pressure coming out into the third quarter was much more tenacious than it was in the first half altogether.
Well, I think the big thing was that, Ian West and Spoon and them controlling the boards, I think, it somewhat limited their fast break. You know, I didn't realize it at first, but now I realize they didn't get a lot of fast breaks in the second half, and that's when they really get their momentum and start hurting you.
Yes. Big ball game, Phil. Congratulations. Now back over to Brent.
All right, Oscar, thank you very much. And so Sonny Hill back down to Washington for game two, and the burden is on the Celtics. They've got to win a game down there in Landover.
It looks like we're going to have one of those flip-flop series where the team will lose at home and win on the road. I look for this series to go six or seven games, and I still think it's going to be the classic type of series everyone was talking about before.
Here are some highlights.
Here's a big play here. Strong rebounding on the part of the Bullets. This time it's Mike Reardon with his aggressive play, and this is the start of the second half when the Bullets came out very aggressive. And here's a good play, a swing play away from the ball, the weak side, and Hayes goes back door and he ends up with a field goal down tight. Here's a very good move by Paul Westphal as he picked up the loose ball and went in for a very creative shot. And here's another hustling play on the part of the Washington Bullets. Hayes comes in very strong. He misses this shot. Now watch the aggressive play of Hayes. This is the thing that Oscar was talking about when he interviewed him, the things that not always show up in the box score. Ends up with a slam dunk, but more important, the way he went after the ball after he missed the first shot. And Witherspoon, as we indicated before, came off the bench, did a good job. And here's a strong tapping on a missed shot by Phil Chenier of that Witherspoon shot. JoJo White was the man coming down the stretch who really tried to pull the game out for the Boston Celtics. He made some very clutch shots for them, but unfortunately, the Celtics were not able to get enough of him. And here's a big play by Phil Chenier as he not only hits the jump shot, but watch this situation as he steals the inbounds play. And that's the kind of aggressive play that the Washington Bullets showed this afternoon, and that's what enabled them to win the ball game.
Sonny, I tell you, there's a very interesting statistic about the Boston Celtics. In the last 3 years, they have never lost more than two games in a row, and they've done that only three times.
In 1961, Arnold Palmer's superb golf attracted an army of followers who thrilled to his great shot-making and shared in his exuberant joy. Win or lose, and it was usually win, if there was a dramatic finish, it was a good bet that Arnie would be there. The 1961 Masters finish between Palmer and Gary Player, here coming out of a bunker on the 72nd hole, was perhaps the most dramatic of all. Here's Gary finishing his weakest round of the tournament with a 74 for what seemed a second place to Palmer. But Gary Player was about to get the surprise of his life. Here's Arnie right behind Player with a short iron to the 18th green for what should be an easy par four to win it all. Even a bogey five will get Arnie a tie. But the shot went offline into the same trap Gary Player just came out of. Here's Arnie coming out, trying to lay it up close for the par, but he hits it over the green. Now he's lying three. What seemed to be an easy victory is becoming a nightmare. Here's Arnie coming back, trying to get close enough to sink his putt for the tie. He's way past the pin. Arnie must make this putt, or it's all over. Oh. The tap-in for a six gives Palmer a double bogey on the 72nd hole of the 1961 Masters. Just like a duffer, he's lost it all. Let's play it again. Remember, Arnie was lying one when he hit this short iron towards the green. The shot goes off into the trap, but there's no real trouble at this point. The crucial error was this shot hit over the green, some 30 feet away from the flag. But still a chance to tie if Arnie can lay it up close. He's well past the pin and misses his chance for a tie with this putt coming back. It's all over except for a memorable quote from Mr. Palmer. He said, "I thought sixes only happened to other people." In 1961, Arnie Blewett and Gary Player won the most coveted prize in golf, the Masters Championship. How nice to play it again.
And that was Jack Whitaker with a nostalgic look at Arnold Palmer. Now, next week, don't forget on CBS, two more playoff games on Saturday afternoon. We'll have Game 3 of the showdown between the Washington Bullets and the Boston Celtics. Then on Sunday, we'll move to Chicago. You will pick up a playoff game between Golden State and the Bulls. They will get that series underway tonight out in Oakland. And this is Brett Musburger for Oscar Robertson and Sonny Hill, saying goodbye from the Boston Garden, where the final score is Washington 100, Boston 95.
And let's see how the ball's gonna bounce today. Welcome to
NBA Playoffs, sponsored by Ford and your local Ford dealer. The closer you look, the better we look. And by Dutch Masters, the fine cigar made with four Latin American tobaccos.
When you watch the NBA on CBS.
NBA Playoffs are a presentation of CBS Sports.